cash, they have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You may think that performance-enhancing drugs can help you hit the ball harder, help you throw the ball farther, make you bigger, stronger, faster, and more attractive to scouts. But performance-enhancing drugs won't make you a champion. To do that, you have to challenge yourself. At the Illinois High School Association, we're committed to making sure that today's high school athletes understand the dangers of using performance-enhancing drugs. This message is brought to you by the Illinois High School Association, inviting student-athletes, parents, and fans alike to challenge yourself and help bring out the best in our high schools and communities.
You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you can start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
It doesn't matter what sport he plays. It doesn't matter how many hits she gets. It doesn't matter if your child's a born champion or if ice water flows through their veins. What does matter is that you, their parent, practice good sportsmanship by respecting the opposing team, their fans, and the officials. It isn't always easy, but if you can be a good sport and conduct yourself with the same measure of dignity and grace that we demand from our high school athletes, everyone's a winner. Sportsmanship. Are you up for the challenge? This message is brought to you by the IHSA, celebrating more than 100 years of high school sports and activities in Illinois.
Tom Waddle here, and I know you've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? Interested, aren't you? Don't waste another minute. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. Classes taught by industry pros with affordable tuition and job placement assistance. Apply now for spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you could start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports. Your friend Tom Waddle here. You've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? You're interested, aren't you? So why haven't you done anything about it? Don't waste another minute in a career you don't love. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or TV reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, you'll learn key skills from industry pros while working with professional equipment on air and behind the scenes. Still need to keep the 9-to-5 job? Their flexible class schedules can work around any schedule. Short on cash? They have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need the skills to work in the industry. This is Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night and instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. ICB provides hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn how to work on air and behind the scenes. With internships and job placement assistance at stations like ESPN Chicago, you can start a new career in a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. You know you want to be here. That's beonair.com/...
Again, welcome into the broadcast. Stephen Duffy, Marcus Grassman. Tommy Castagnola is going to be behind the Huskies bench. We'll talk to him after the first period. And Brian Riske is going to be doing the stats, and he'll jump on and do the second period with Stephen Duffy, as well as the entire ChicagolandSportsRadio.com crew here helping us with the cameras. Townsend and Rosinski in the faceoff circle, and we're underway. Troy Herland gets the puck, dumps it in on Davis, blocked there by Sadorf. Here's Eric Oleg. Shot quick by Rosinski, goes up and over the net. Riccardi far side half boards, ice bear zone. Leon trying to track it down, battles there with Leslie at the point from Herland. That stunned Townsend a little bit, but he's all right. Finally taken by Aldag. Aldag can't clear out, finally does out to the Fox Valley logo. Coletta pumps this one back in on the goaltender, and Rosinski's going to go off for a change. Out comes John Luciana. Leslie for the Ice Bears dumps it in, and the Ice Bears are going to go for their first change 40 seconds into this contest. Nick Leon up to center ice. Hellman Maki grabs it there, and he swings it into the Husky zone. Right back out is Leon, looking for and finding John Luciana. He gets tripped, no penalty called. Jack Ryan, the leading point scorer from last year with 62 points, is on the ice with Yusel Helmanmaki, Hoglund. It's Kovacic and Bobby Brown. Brian Pounds in his own zone, left side half boards, left faceoff circle as Helmanmaki shoots that one through the blue crease. Greenberg tries to backhand it out. He does. He finds Eric Sveda. Sveda a little room, but it just escapes his stick where Yusel Helmanmaki can recover. Bobby Brown goes up through the middle, finds Jack Ryan over the Fox Valley logo, gains the Husky zone at the left point, whiffs on a shot, good defensive play there by Pounds, and he's going to grab the puck. Finds and connects with Eric Sveda. Sveda has some room, left side, 2-on-1 with Greenberg. Sveda shoots, big save made by Davis. First test of the night for the goaltender. Had Greenberg wide open if he would have passed it. Nothing doing, 18-19 left in the first, no score.
And again, we saw Brian Pounds there having a good sequence on defense. Obviously, we know that he hasn't played defense since he's been here at NIU. He hasn't played defense actually for like 7 years. But he's actually a pretty good defenseman. He obviously did a good job there getting the puck back and getting up to Sveda. And Sveda ended up getting a nice shot off on Davis.
Here's the next line out for Chuck Rinaldo. Nick Gorsica, or Gorsica, Nedzla, and Tommy Turner with the freshman defensive pairing of that's Turner and Mano. And who's the 0-24? That's Robles on that third line. Brandon Edzela's got it. Pushes it up to Gorsica, trying to connect with Patrick Robles just outside of his reach. Bouchard swings it back into his own zone. He controls and settles things down. Robles tried to break up the pass. He does just enough. Streaking in is Alex Turin, but Robles breaks him off the puck. The Ice Bears send this win in on Alex Ayer. He stops the puck. Let's Tommy Turner take over. Going for Gorsica off the boards, can't clear it out. Here's Bouchard with Nedzla, and it's Robles to clear out to center ice. Now Tommy Turner sends it in right side corner boards, and the Huskies are going to go for a change. And that's going to be an icing call, I believe, on the Ice Bears. Whistle blows, 17:32 left in the first, no score. And that was one of the problems I felt that the Huskies had with last week is not getting the puck out up off the glass. You're trying to make those passes through the middle.
Yeah, well, I mean, but you saw that Gorsica, he made the better move. Instead of passing it to the middle like they were last week, he just kind of tried to glance it off the boards, almost ended up getting it out, but at least that's a better move than passing it in the middle of your own zone.
Aldag swings it around, kept in Ron Coletta at the left point in the Ice Bear zone. This one deflects almost into the net. It went off of Max Finley's stick. Coletta goes off of Finley's face now, and it gets back into the Ice Bear zone. Taken by Alex Nana. Nana gets taken off the puck by Finley. Finley stops, reverses sides, back to the point left side for Troy Herland. Herland likes to shoot, takes a shot, gets deflected right of the goaltender. Finley and Cantillo out there now with Serpico. Serpico keeps it in. Finley goes down low, left side corner boards, Ice Bear zone. Swings it around looking for Bouchard, and Coletta can't keep it in, and the Ice Bears go for a change. Here's Troy Herland, back for Coletta. They play catch in their own zone. Herland now up off the boards, looking for Finley. Finley's going to go for a change as the first line comes back out onto the ice for the Huskies, Leon Rosinski and Riccardi. Here's Helmanmaki, has it taken away by Justin Rosinski. Rosinski looking for Riccardi, shoots, big save, where is it? And it's underneath Davis. He looked back as if he didn't know where that was. 16:22 left in the first, no score, and so far the Huskies have had two grade A scoring opportunities.
Well, yeah, and the defense is doing much better this game in NIU, so obviously they're getting some nice scoring chances because of defense. Defense turns into offense, and I think they're doing much better today instead of last week from U of I. And great pass by Rosinski. Riccardi ended up almost getting a pass Davis, and Davis wasn't even sure where it was.
Rosinski wins the faceoff, Pounds backhands it into the left side half boards. Rosinski and Townsend battle there, along with Leon. Rosinski gets taken down, no penalty called. Now Matt Townsend gets taken down, again, no penalty. A couple tripping penalties could have been called, but the refs let him play
refs,
on.
Refs are definitely being very lenient today.
Here's Anthony Riccardi, has it taken away by Bobby Brown. Brown reverses to Leslie up the right side, half boards in the Ice Bear zone. Now goes around the opposite side for Matt Townsend. Townsend can't clear the puck. Rosinski bothers him, Bobby Brown off the puck, but Brown comes out through center ice, gains the line, winds, fires, and it goes just wide. And the whistle blows. It's going to be an offsides play on the Ice Bears as Brad Keenan points to himself saying, was that me? Did I do that? You did. Whistle blows, 15:38 left in period number one.
Well, and I noticed kind of, I think Missouri State, it looks like some of their players didn't make it down for the trip. I mean, I'm not seeing some of their numbers out there. Adam Thor. I'm sorry, thinking of the name, but there's a couple guys that are definitely missing from today's game because obviously it's a long trip all the way up to NIU.
This one gets dumped back in by Kellen Patrick. Patrick Schwartz now out for his defensive partner, Pounds. Pounds for Sveda on the left side, half boards in the Husky zone. Kept in nicely there by Andrew Kovacic. Kovacic has it taken away by Pounds. Pounds now for Greenberg. Greenberg has it taken away off his puck. He kind of whiffed on it. But Pounds is able to not clear the zone. Good keep in there by the Ice Bears, number 24, Kellen Patrick. Luciana can't get it out. Huskies having a tough time right now getting the puck out of their own zone. Finally, Sveda does, looking for Greenberg. Greenberg goes around his man. That's Patrick. He stops as the Huskies are off for a change, so it was a 1-on-5 for Greenberg. Here's Eric Sveda behind the net. Goes around to the left side, half boards for Ron Coletta. Now taken by Greenberg up off the corner for Sveda. Sveda centering temp and right to Jack Ryan, and out come the Ice Bears. Ice Bears gain the line left side. Jack Ryan goes through the legs, pad save made by Alex Hare. Jack Ryan gets it back for Leslie. Puck bounces to Otten, and Otten fires wide. Haven't seen Otten yet in this game. Finally gets his first shift 6 minutes into the game. Big Troy Herland gains the line at the right point. Now right face-off circle, Ice Bear zone. Looking to go back, but no one was there at the defensive position as the Huskies were going for a change. Herland can't get it in. Now it's Roble. Roble finds and gains the line left side, backhands it right side, corner boards, Missouri State zone. Puck pops up to the right face-off circle, taken by Aldag. Aldag reverses, now left side circle. Comes out through the middle of the ice. Good stick there by Tommy Turner to deny Bouchard a scoring opportunity. Center attempt by Turin. Goes back to the point. Sadar shot right in the breadbasket. Well, first shot on goal for Missouri State. Alex Hare makes the save into the chest. 13:38 left in the first. No score.
And you're seeing Alex Hare. He's getting a little bit more work here in the last couple minutes because they're now starting to get some scoring chances on him. Looks like NIU's slowing down just a little bit. And Missouri State's taking advantage of it, but Alex Harris denied him a couple times. A very good save, Berman.
Mano gets ran over in the corner by Keenan. No icing. Good hustle there by Nick Leon to negate it. He's looking for a center attempt. No one was there. Went right into the stick of Alex Nana. Here's a shot coming into the glove as Hare went to play. That shot came from the point from a clue. Now Rosinski backhands it, not out. Kept in by Bobby Brown. Now Rosinski's just going to stick it to the center, to the middle of the ice. Leon gets it there. Now Brown back in. Here's Justin Rosinski. He's taken down. And here's the first penalty of the game. Missouri State as Leon whiffs on the pass. Whistle blows. 12:58 left. The first Huskies are going to get their first power play of the night.
Well, and that's the nice thing about Justin Rosinski and Nick Leon. They're not just good scorers. They're good stick handlers. So people are so worried about them that they don't want them to get behind them because they're such good stick handlers. And you saw it right there, Justin Rosinski doing a good job of gaining the line, but they ended up having to trip him. So then they get their first penalty of the game and their first power play.
That just tells you how well Rosinski moves his feet.
Yep.
So you got Luciana, Riccardi, Rosinski, Leon, and Herland out there. Same first power play unit that we saw against the University of Illinois.
And they actually got a power play against on their first chance.
Here's Nick Leon now. Sauces it over for Rosinski, right face-off circle in the Ice Bear zone. Rosinski skates around, now left side, protects the puck, gets taken down. I think he was doing a little bit too much there as a one man. Now Leon back in his own zone for Troy Herland. Back for Rosinski in the middle of the ice. Drop pass for Riccardi. Gains the line right point. Now to the right face of the circle. Right point for Rosinski. Gets blocked out in front. Missouri State does clear the puck just barely. Keenan goes for a change. And Pounds looking for Rosinski as the second power play unit. Their first power play unit is still out on the ice. Now they go for a change.
And it looks like Coach Chuck is still going with that second power play unit of last week of Sveda, Greenberg, and Luciana on that second power play unit line.
Luciana gains the line, goes around a check, tries the little floater up and over, goes down to right half boards. Now Sveda. Sveda gets taken down, but Greenberg picks it up. Greenberg gets taken off the puck, and Missouri State clears it. 40 seconds left on the power play. 11:39 left in period number one.
So far, no chances for NIU. They really haven't been able to get into the middle of the zone, of Missouri State's zone, to really get any good chances against Missouri State's penalty kill.
Pounds finds Sveda over the middle of the ice. Hellman Maki rubs him off the puck, so the Huskies have to regroup. Back is Tommy Turner, number 21. Cross ice for Nedzela. Nedzela back for Turner. They play catch in their own zone. Greenberg, touch pass, is going to find Nedzela in the offensive zone. That's a great play. Gets taken down. No penalty called. Sveda and McClue battle. McClue Brown. Sveda, and they got a little fight going on now behind the net as they bunch up. And both teams are at full strength. 10:50 left in the first. Finally, Missouri State's Brown comes out with it, looking for Townsend. Townsend gets it out to the middle of the ice, neutral ice. Pound skates, waits, gonna reverse. Good stick there, but I think, again, the Huskies just doing a little bit too much individual play. They need to get that puck in and work the forecheck. Cantillo out there now with Max Finley and Mark Greenberg. Here's Finley looking for Cantillo, and Finley whiffed on the shot. Davis is going to cover up. 10:19 left in the first. Very unproductive first power play.
Well, so far, I mean, you've seen a lot of whiffs from NIU Huskies. Even though they had a game last week, it still looks like they're maybe a little bit rusty, a little bit nervous of their first conference game, and you're seeing a lot of whiffs from them. And it's just too bad because they could be getting a lot of really good shots on Davis, but so far just not really a lot of good grade-A opportunities, maybe a couple, but there could be a lot more if they were getting the good shots.
Good keep in there by Serpico. Serpico's out there with Finley and Cantillo. Now taken away and controlled by Kovacic. Kovacic looking cross-ice and not finding Jack Ryan. Now it's Finley. Finley gains the line and just dumps the puck in deep. Let the forecheck work. Patrick grabs it for Missouri State. Now looking for Patrick. Patrick finds Ryan but jumps off his stick, and Herland's able to control and dump it back into the Missouri State zone. Patrick along with PJ Adams, Jack Ryan, Kovacic, and Hoglin out there for Missouri State right now. Jack Ryan spins away over the Coors Light logo. Bothered there by Serpico and Leon. Now drop pass back for Patrick. Patrick now for Adams. Adams dumps it in off the glove of Schwartz. Here comes out and plays it. Almost picked off, and it is by Jack Ryan. Ryan shoots and blocks it away, does Alex Ayer to the right side half boards. Now in the corner. Schwartz battles with Kovacic. The bigger Schwartz gains the puck. Now it goes over. Bouchard's there to pick it off for Hoglin. Kovacic gives it away to Leon. Leon looking for and finding Riccardi in front of the Missouri State bench. Trying to go through. Here's Leon, and he's trying to dive. And now we got a scrum. It's Aldag and Leon. And I think it might be matching penalties here as Riccardi went diving in for a loose puck.
Well, obviously, I mean, we know that Nick Leon's a little bit of a hothead. I mean, he had a couple penalties last week, and he does not like to get pushed around, even though he's a smaller guy. And it looks like it's going to be a penalty against Nick Leon. Now, I'm not sure if it's going to be offsetting penalties, but I think it's just, yeah, it's going to be offsetting penalties like you thought there, Marcus, and it's going to be Aldeck and Leon.
They're chirping at each other
and
inside
still
the penalty box.
They're still chirping at each other even when they get in the penalty box. And now it looks like it's going to be Luciana, Turner, Nedzela, and Schwartz on the 4-on-4, on the first 4-on-4 out there.
As the ref is still talking to Aldag in the box, 4-on-4, Luciana, Schwartz, Nedzla, and Turner. Taken now by Yuso Helmanmaki. He gains the line, comes up through middle of the ice. Now Schwartz controls, looking for Turner. Actually, I don't think it was a pass, just was going off the boards. Here's John Luciana, gains the line. And actually doesn't. Refs are going to say it's an offsides play. It's a little bit, or one too many steps there for Luciana. 8:30 left in the first. 1:37 left on matching minors to Leon and Aldag.
Well, you saw Auden and number 9, Bouchard. He kind of get a little bit of stick in there just to kind of disrupt Luciana. So he couldn't quite do the stick handles that he wanted to. And that's why the offsides ended up going, because Nedzla just went it a little bit too early.
Townsend now gives it back for Helmanmaki. Grabs it for Patrick. As Schwartz had Townsend lined up. And there's a big hit there by P.J. Adams on Eric Sveda. And right now, Missouri State has been the aggressor in the hitting department. Back four, and it grabbing is Patrick. Patrick gets it out to neutral ice. Eric Sveda's there. Now back for Turner. Turner just dumps it back into the middle of the ice where Missouri State can control. P.J. Adams goes and finds Townsend connecting with the pass. Back for Kellen. Kellen shoots that one, goes up over the glass, over the crossbar off the glass. This one goes all the way down. This is going to be icing against Northern Illinois. 7:45 left in the first. Matching penalties with 50 seconds left to Leon and Aldag.
You know, so far, I mean, I think both teams have had some couple graded chances. In the first 13 minutes of the game, both have had penalties now. We had the one power play, lone power play, couldn't do anything with it. So far, I think that's a very good game so far. You thought that maybe Missouri State was going to come out guns a-blazing and get some more goals, but I think maybe because of the long road trip, 10 hours like we had to do last year, I think they're a little bit, you could see, it, I guess you could say tired out there. So
yeah.
I think maybe in the second period you'll see them kind of go out there a lot more, a lot faster. So NIU just better be ready in that second period.
Face-off won and controlled by Missouri State. Sador shoots, scores! Sador scores from the point. I believe it was deflected out in front. Missouri State on the 4-on-4 grabs the lead with 7:36 left in the first.
Well, yeah, and that's what you got to do when you're especially on a 4-on-4, you're just trying to get pucks in the net, and that's exactly what Sador did there. And like you said, it looked like it was tipped in, and Alex there really couldn't do a lot about it. And that's what you just got to do, just get pucks in the net, and you could get tip-ins or garbage goals like they just did there. And now it's 1-0, and they have the momentum for the next at least couple minutes in this period.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if it deflected off a Missouri State player out in front or if that could have been a Northern player.
It could have been off a Northern player as well.
As Hare grabs this one, he's going to get a whistle. 7:26 left in the first. Coming up right after the first period, we're going to send it down to Tommy. He's going to talk with junior forward Anthony Riccardi on the bench. So make sure you stay tuned to that. He will then talk to Coach Ronaldo after period number two. Ron Coletta can't get it out of the zone. Kept in there nicely by Sadorf. Sadorf now for Kovacic. Now Rosinski up off the glass again. Good keep in there by Sadorf. Sadorf for Kovacic. Handles the puck. Odd angle shot blocked away by Alex Hare. This one goes all the way down back in the Missouri State zone. Not far enough for icing. Sadorf can grab it. Now Greenberg gets ran into. It looked like a headshot almost. No penalty called. No, I was thinking, too, the one guy we haven't seen yet this game is Jouch.
Yeah, we saw him dress up, but I don't think we've seen that fourth line a lot. And Jouch, like last week, they're just kind of put in four guys in that fourth line.
I mean, he's on the bench, just has not had a shift yet as the Huskies are off sides with 6:40 left in the first. 1-0 Ice Bears.
It looks like it's going to go back to that. I think that third line of Serpico, Korziga, and Nedzla. Actually, it's Nedzla. I'm sorry, Roble and Gorzikov.
Yep. Yeah. Pounds and Schwartz for the Huskies. Now 5-on-5. Franco chips this one in right side corner boards into the Huskies zone. Hare backhands it around. Westcott's there. Gets a pretty good jolt by Schwartz. Centering attempt. Good stick tied up there by Gorzika. And out come the Huskies. Here's Roble with some speed. Going to get the puck. No icing called. Good speed there by Roble. Center attempt gets blocked by Gorzika out in front, so no shot attempt there. Roble now back to the top of the faceoff circle, winds, fires, and Davis pads that one away. And I believe it goes out of play. 6:05 left in the first, 1-0 in favor of Missouri State.
I was very impressed with that shot by Roble there. He wasn't even looking at the net, and he just turns around and throws out a slap shot. Yeah, blind fire there, a slap shot. Almost ended up getting by Davis. I think Davis was a little bit caught off guard, so that's why he barely got a piece of it.
In the face-off circle, we're going to have Otten against Luciana to the left of Davis in the Ice Bear zone.
And then the freshman defensive pair, Mano and Turner.
Face-off won but controlled by one of five captains, Nick Sadorf. Luciana grabs it, has it taken away from him, but Roble is able to control. Or that's Turner. Turner, Greenberg, Mano, Luciana, and Sveda. Here's Luciana. Big man has some speed. Greenberg's going to dump this in, and they're going to go for a change. Back now is Turin. Turin has it taken away by Luciana. That one, centering pass went through Sveda and Greenberg. They got 3-on-1. Turner, 3-on-1. There is a shot. Big save made by Heron. I think it might have went off the crossbar. Here's Greenberg now. Greenberg stops, looks, and finds Rosinski. Back for Greenberg, fires. That one goes wide, glove side of Davis. It looks like Greenberg might have been shaken up just a little bit on the play. But a 3-on-1, and Missouri State hits the iron. Bouchite gains the line. Santas looking for Otten. Otten shoots right in the pads of Hare. He's going to cover up because we have a little bit of extracurriculars after the whistle. 4:58 left in the first, 1-0 in favor of Missouri State.
Well, even though that Missouri State hit the crossbar, Alex Hare had a good sequence there really to make it tough for them to really find a lane or to find a good shot on him, and that's why he made it so tough on him, and that's why I think they hit the crossbar. And also Tommy Turner did a good job there of keeping the lanes out of the passing lane so they can't pass it across for each other. So Tommy Turner and Alex Hare, good sequence there.
Face-off won by Missouri State, if I can get that out. Hare made the pad save. Coletta goes around, kept in. Nope, just jumps over the stick of Brown. He's got to regroup. Finds Hellman-Mackey. Hellman-Mackey gains the line, takes a shot, gets deflected by Herland. Goes just squiggling by Alex Hare. Now Ron Coletta's got it. He's got some skating room, comes up through the middle of the ice. Looking for Zinski, can't find him, but Townsend's there to grab it for Keenan. Back for Hellman-Mackey. Has it taken away by Nick Leon. Has his stick tied up, can't get it free. This one goes back to the point for Ron Coletta. Wines, fires, and he was looking for a deflection out in front. Herland takes a shot. Centering time, oh, and good chance for Leon, but an even better play by Brad Keenan to slide and take that puck away. Here's a boarding call coming up. Here's Bobby Brown, and Brown's getting taken around by Leon, and Brown should get tossed from this one.
Wow, Brown just took Nick Leon down like a wrestler there. He just like threw him down to the ice. Obviously, Nick Leon getting into it again with another player, and he's going right off the ice. Bobby Brown, and I'm not sure if Nick Leon's going to go off as well, but man, what a pass there by Riccardi right into the middle of the ice to almost find Nick Leon, and Nick Leon is still jawing at people.
This is going to be interesting. Is they going to say Leon's going to go to the penalty box too? So right now, Bobby Brown in the box. That was a vicious hit from behind.
Do we want to maybe go over to Tommy Castronova?
He doesn't look like he's ready enough.
I don't know. I mean, we've got a long pause here.
That's
could
right.
Go over to Tommy.
He doesn't have a headset. We can't even tell him what we're talking about. As everything's getting set up here, right now Brown's the only one in the box. And I think that's all it's gonna remain. Herland getting the call as well as Eric Aldag. So just a 2-minute minor for Brown.
Yeah, I thought maybe you would get maybe a 4-minute there because he threw down Nick Leon to the ice like it was nothing.
Trying to figure out what the actual call is here on Brown.
So 4 minutes left in the first period, only one goal in the game.
One goal in the game, and I would believe that Missouri State is leading in the shot category.
Yeah, I would say maybe by a couple shots, but NIU is, I think, had the first 5 or 6 minutes of the game, and then Missouri State kind of took over the last 10 minutes. So if NIU can take over in this power play, they can maybe get a goal and tie this thing back up and take the momentum back.
All right, 5-on-4 power play for the Huskies. Rosinski, Herland, Luciana, Leon, and Riccardi. Here's Luciana. He gains the line, takes a shot, blockered away by Davis to the left side corner boards. That one skips over Luciana's stick, now taken by Franco, and he clears it back out to neutral ice. Troy Herland now gives it over for Leon in front of the Huskies bench with 3:35 left in the first, 1:30 left in period number one. Now it's Riccardi. Riccardi goes around Davis, escapes the check, now back to the point for Osinski. Down low. Oh, that deflected just wide. Davis had no clue where it was. Luciana back as Stripes goes down. And a
that was a bad fall there by the ref.
All right, a misplay here by the Huskies. Here's Jack Ryan, gains the line, right point. Now it's Keenan. Keenan's center attempt goes just wide. Jack Ryan grabs it now. And the Huskies have 54 seconds left of power play time here in period number one, trailing 1-0. As Herland curls around, has it taken away from him. And it's Keenan and Ryan on the good forecheck penalty kill there with 2:35 left in the first. Here's Rosinski. Rosinski trying to gain the line, can't do it, and the Ice Bears clear it all the way back down. Alex Harry passes it over for Pounds now. Pounds escapes the check from Ryan. He backhands it into the zone, but not deep enough. The Ice Bears are able to clear it back out to center ice. 14 left on the power play, 2:14 left in period number one. Huskies find themselves down 1-0. Here's Nedzla, backhands it down for Sveda. Sveda and Patrick battle for it. Patrick gets taken down. Here's centering attempt for Nedzla, and he couldn't pull the trigger. Brown out of the box. Both teams at full strength, 2 minutes left in period number one.
I think Nedzla, without a stick there, was looking for a slash. I think somebody took a stick out from him. Didn't quite get the call there, though.
As an icing is called on the Huskies with 1:46 left in the first, and they just have not been able to get any kind of consistency in the power play unit tonight so far.
Obviously, they've had some good passes. They've had some good chances, but just nothing really on net on Davis. I mean, they just haven't really been able to finish it. So, obviously, I mean, they really got to work on that power play, especially in the second period, if they want to get back in this game and have some momentum going into the period.
Hoglund and Serpico in the faceoff zone. Pounds swings it around, right side half boards in the Husky zone. Serpico's going to backhand this one out to neutralize over the Aurora logo. Now Aldag. Aldag looking for Bouchard. He gets taken off the puck nicely by Pounds. Schwartz has it taken away by Otten. And this one comes back up to boards. Sveda can't grab it and get it out, so the Ice Bears dump it back in. Pounds now without a stick gets taken out. Centering attempt here for Otten, and he can't get anything on it. Sveda's not able to clear. Now it's Serpico trying to go up off the glass. He does, but it doesn't get out. Huskies just reeling in their own zone with 1 minute left here in period number one. Find themselves down by only a goal. Adam Ott now left side corner boards, Husky zone. Now Pounds and Otten battle for it. Pounds wins the puck. Backhands it. Cross ice for Greenberg. Gee just gets it out. And a couple Huskies are going to go for a quick change with 45 left in period number one. Riccardi gets it through the middle of the ice. Serpico just chops at it and gets it back into his offensive zone. Nick Sadorf goes off the boards, finding Jack Ryan. Stick lifted by Leon. Now Rosinski gains the line, takes a shot blockered away there by Davis, and it went right back to Rosinski. Just couldn't get a shot on it. 20 seconds left in the first. Big hit there by Nick Leon on Otten, and he gets right back up. Center attempt, here is Rosinski, shoots, tries to go, top shelf, and with 7.5 left, puck goes out of play. First period, 1-0 to score, 7.5 left in period number one.
Really good sequence there by Nick Leon and Justin Rosinski. I mean, obviously, Justin Rosinski, he did a really good job of getting into the zone, following up his own shot, and going for the goal. Almost ended up getting by Davis the second time, but just couldn't quite get a lot on the shot. And then Nick Leon basically taking out all his frustrations after getting pushed around the last couple times, taking out all of his frustrations on that hit, and that was a big hit by Nick Leon to get the puck back.
Justin Rosinski loses the faceoff to Aldag. This one gets cleared, and that's going to do it for period number one, as the Huskies are going to find themselves down 1-0 after period one here of the home opener. Thoughts on period number one, Duffy?
I thought period number one was a very good, not a very good period by NIU, but I thought it was a good period. Stay with Missouri State, only down one goal to a very big offensive team. And obviously you're seeing that by NIU. I mean, not too bad of a period by Alex Hare. Had some good saves, letting that one goal, but I thought it was a very good period by him. And then Missouri State, all the NIU needs to do, if they get a couple power play chances, they need to get a better chance to really get it to the goal.
Now we're going to send it down to Tommy Castronovo, who has head coach Chuck Rinaldo down on ice level.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me today. Here with Coach Chuck Rinaldo of NIU Hockey. Coach, a bit of a up and down first period for you guys. You gave them out pretty fast in the first. How did you think you guys played?
Good start. We just had a little bit of a lull in the middle of the period. Kind of got a little complacent, but, you know, they worked hard. It could have gone either way. They got a lucky bounce off a shin pad, and, you know, we could have had the same lucky pounce. Unfortunately, we're due next period.
Now, one of the things you guys were so good last year was on the power play. You guys had a couple of good chances here in the first period. Do you expect for that line to start clicking more as the going gets tough?
Yeah, you know, I mean, they put a lot of pressure on the power play. So when we get an opportunity, we got to take advantage of it. You know, unfortunately, we got a couple bad bounces. We couldn't quite capitalize. But, you know, if we get a few more power plays, we'll take advantage.
And something I also noticed as well is that you guys have a little bit more speed than Missouri State does. They're looking to play a more physical game. Do you think you're going to try to up that speed, and which will create more turnovers for you guys?
Well, they're going to take a lot of chances. We know that. So, you know, we just have to keep converting, keep looking for those indirects off the boards. We'll get a lot of odd man breaks. We just got to capitalize on them.
Yeah, and another big guy that stepped up for you guys last year, Alex Hare. He had a pretty good first period for himself. Hopefully you guys don't have to put the whole load on him in the second and third periods.
Yeah, you know, we hope to take any pressure off of him that's there. He'll make the first save. We just got to clear things out for him and transition quickly.
Now, is there going to be any major adjustments that you're going to have to talk to your guys about in the second period, going for the third period as well?
No, you know, we got to keep our head down and just work hard. You know, they're trying to start some dirty stuff after the whistle and stuff. You know, I mean, they got a call for doing that, so the refs see it. So we can't retaliate and take advantage when they do15 it.
Well, we look forward to another couple good pitches from you guys. Good luck there.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, Tommy, down there with head coach Chuck Rinaldo. Coming up after our first commercial break here on the intermission report, we will break down period number one, look at the shot and faceoff total, because I think that told a big story of period number one, and we'll preview period number two. After 20 minutes of play here at Fox Valley, Huskies find themselves down 1-0. You're listening to Huskies Hockey on ChicagolandSportsRadio.com.
Tom Waddle here, and I know you've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? Interested, aren't you? Don't waste another minute. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. Classes taught by industry pros with affordable tuition and job placement assistance. Apply now for spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you could start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Your friend Tom Waddle here. You've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? You're interested, aren't you? So why haven't you done anything about it? Don't waste another minute in a career you don't love. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or TV reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, you'll learn key skills from industry pros while working with professional equipment on air and behind the scenes. Still need to keep the 9-to-5 job? Their flexible class schedules can work around any schedule. Short on cash? They have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports? You have drive and determination, but you need the skills to work in the industry. This is Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. ICB provides hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn how to work on air and behind the scenes with internships and job placement assistance at stations like ESPN Chicago. You can start a new career in a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. You know you want to be here. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You can have a new career in 1 year. This is Tom Waddle for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get caught in the high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or television career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you get. Flexible class schedules, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports today. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Start a new career in 1 year. What's up? It's Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get stuck with high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or TV career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you'll get. Flexible day and night classes, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You know you want to. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
And we're back here at Fox Valley Ice Arena. First intermission report here. Huskies find themselves trailing 1-0. When you look at the shot total, Missouri State had 11 shots, 11 to 9. A lot closer than I thought it was in that first period. Faceoffs were actually tied, which I thought, again, Missouri State did a better job of controlling faceoffs.
Well, yeah, they did. But like I said, I mean, it was a very close period. Both teams are very fast. Both can be very physical. So obviously it's a very good game so far. I think just so far NIU has not been able to capitalize on the power play chances like Coach Chuck said that they need to do in the second period if they want to have a chance of getting back in this game. Even though they're down only one goal, they need to get they need to do much better on the power play. Haven't really had to go on the penalty kill yet, but the 1-4-on-4, they let that one goal in. But like Coach Chuck said, I mean, it was an unlucky bounce. They could have gotten many of those as well, NIU. So obviously, it could have went either way that period. But so far, Missouri State has got the momentum going into the second period. Let's hope NIU can get it back.
And as we heard in the interview with Chuck Rinaldo there, that, you know, they were right in that first period. I mean, they were matching them shift for shift. If it wasn't just for an unlucky deflection off a shin pad, this would be a tie game, no score after the 20 minutes. But what are some adjustments that Chuck Rinaldo is telling his team that he's looking to make to come out in period number two?
I think they got to do a much better job of getting the puck out of their own zone. They were having a tough time getting the puck out of their own. Like last year. Last year they were having a lot of trouble getting the puck out of their own zone. Let's hope it's not the same this year. So far in this first period, they were having a little bit of trouble with that. So let's hope that they do a little bit better of just sending it up the boards a lot harder than they have been. They've been trying to do that. Luckily, they haven't been making a lot of careless passes into the middle of the ice. So luckily, no like big chances for Missouri State. So that's good, but they just still need to get a better job of getting the puck out of their zone.
All right, we're going to take our last commercial break here of the intermission report. When we come back, Stephen Duffy and Ryan Riske will have the play. I will be the Pierre McGuire of the broadcast. After one period of play, Huskies find themselves down 1-0. You're listening to Huskies Hockey on ChicagolandSportsRadio.com.
Tom Waddle here, and I know you've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? Interested, aren't you? Don't waste another minute. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. Classes taught by industry pros with affordable tuition and job placement assistance. Apply now for spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you could start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Your friend Tom Waddle here. You've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? You're interested, aren't you? So why haven't you done anything about it? Don't waste another minute in a career you don't love. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or TV reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, you'll learn key skills from industry pros while working with professional equipment on air and behind the scenes. Still need to keep the 9-to-5 job? Their flexible class schedules can work around any schedule. Short on cash? They have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports? You have drive and determination, but you need the skills to work in the industry. This is Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. ICB provides hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn how to work on air and behind the scenes with internships and job placement assistance at stations like ESPN Chicago. You can start a new career in a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. You know you want to be here. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
And welcome back to NIU Huskies Hockey as we are about to start the second period as Missouri State is coming out of their locker room, still waiting for NIU. They're going to switch sides of the ice. I am now the play-by-play, Stephen Duffy. I was the caller in the first period, now I'm play-by-play, and I am joined now by our stats man in the first period, Ryan Riske. Ryan, what did you see in that first period that really you liked out of NIU?
Well, I liked the way they played coming out of the gate. They recorded the first three shots on the game. Riccardi had a big chance. It looked like he just didn't get enough on the shot at the beginning of the game. And then it seemed like after that first penalty, when they didn't even record a shot on that power play, was when the momentum turned into Missouri's favor, because you saw NIU was having trouble getting the puck out of their own zone on multiple occasions.
Yeah, you're definitely right about that. I mean, when you have a good penalty kill, that gives you the momentum for the rest of the period. And like you said, after that first power play, Missouri State kind of took a little bit of the momentum going into the period. Now we're in the second period, so now they're going to have very long shifts, obviously, like you see in hockey. In that second period, you see long shifts, so you see a lot more breakaways in the second period. So let's hope that we can get a couple of those. And now we see NIU coming out. What do you think NIU needs to do in this period to get the momentum back and tie this game back up, Ryan?
Well, it looked like they were hesitant to take shots because they were afraid they're going to get blocked. I don't think I saw it. I think I may have seen one defenseman take a shot that whole period. Like,
yeah,
they were getting to the blue line, then they're passing it back in. They weren't taking the shots. Like, you got to start taking the shots. I mean, they had some great chances. They maybe got to play around with trying to throw someone in front of the net. I saw they were doing a good job trying to tip the puck. Obviously, the Missouri goalie was doing a great job at defending the puck.
Yeah, Davis did a very good job of getting those deflections and stopping them. But obviously, Missouri State, like you said, if you can just get pucks to the net, you could get some lucky goals like Missouri State got that on that first goal that they got. It was a very lucky goal, just a really
it was
deflection.
A tip shot.
Exactly, and that's what you're saying. I mean, if you get shots from the defense, you can get tips, you can get garbage goals if you can just get shots to the net.
Absolutely, that's the one thing they need to do. And NIU looked really good on their faceoffs. They led the faceoff way, and I mean, their guys are getting it done.
And it looks like we're about to get underway here as Townsend and Rosinski are about to take the faceoff, and we're back with the first line of NIU with Riccardi, Rosinski, and Leon. And Rosinski wins the faceoff, gets a nice dump into the zone as Davis knocks it away, and the Ice Bears gets back up to the center ice. Brian Pounds takes it all the way over for Nick Leon, ends up missing him all the way down for number 19, Sadorf. Sadorf gets it over for Keenan. Keenan looking for his teammate Townsend. Tries to get it around by Rosinski, but Rosinski takes a nice tightest puck. Tries to send it to Riccardi. Almost gets it to Leon. Now Brian Pounds takes a shot. Ends up just sends it over to the near side boards. Now Keenan takes the puck back, and he gets it taken away. Riccardi tries to send it to the middle. Ends up getting stopped by the captain, number 8, Aldag. And now Brian Pounds trying to beat Keenan. Keenan ends up beating him out, and Alex Sarah ends up almost getting it taken away by Keenan, and now Alex there backing goal, almost giving the puck away there. Now Keenan back with the puck over Townsend. Townsend tries to take the shot, ends up whiffing, and it gets it back. Oh, no, trying to get it in there, and I'm not sure if it went in. I'm not sure if the ref, I think
it's a goal.
Is it a goal as the ref?
Yeah, it went in. He pointed in. It's a goal.
And it looks like it's going to be a second goal here for Missouri State. Alex there was trying to find the puck, falling all around. and it just couldn't quite find it as Missouri State goes up 2-0, only about a minute here into the period.
Looked like it just barely slid under him. Or it wasn't one of those ones that was hit hard. The puck just rolled in.
Yeah, and it looked like that play kind of got started from Keenan really beating out Brian Pounds there. Brian Pounds is, I think, very mad with himself. He was trying to get back to the puck, but just couldn't quite beat Keenan out. And now it's going to be in the faceoff, the second line for NIU, Luciana. And Luciana ends up losing it. Now Jack Ryan, their big scorer from last year, takes a shot, ends up getting blocked away by Coletta. Coletta ends up getting the puck back, but now loses it to number 20, Kovachuk. Kovachuk loses it now all the way to the other side. And Herland gets it up for Sveda. Sveda now to Luciana. Luciana trying to find some room at the center of the ice. Gains the zone. Luciana looking for a shot. And it was a backhand shot on Davis. Davis decides just to hold that puck and wait for the whistle. And as he does, we're going to get another faceoff with 18:42. Still 2-0 Missouri State.
Looked like he should have passed it to Pounds on that two-on-two break there. Looked like he might have had a chance.
Yeah, I mean, Luciana, it looked like he was just trying to find a shot there. Mm-hmm. But couldn't quite find anybody. Sveda now all the front of the net ends up getting it taken away. And now Kovachuk comes up with a puck, trying to beat Herland out around the puck. Herland does a nice job of there. And now Kovachuk sends it to the middle. Nobody found there. And Greenberg now takes the puck, finds Luciana, and now they get it out of the zone. NIU up with it. Sveda tries to make a move around Brown. Brown takes it. Now a two-on-one for Missouri State if they can hurry. And now Kovachuk looking for a shot. And a good diving save, but it ends up just trickling in after a nice diving poke check there from Coletta.
Yeah, Alex Harry dove and poke checked it, and then it looked like it hit off of a skate, and then it just deflected in. There was nothing he could do about that. It's just a fluke goal right there. I mean, that was a tough break going 2-on-1, and then Sadoff went and drove to the front of the net, got behind the defense.
Yeah, just a good job by Missouri State. I told Marcus in the first period, I was really worried about the second period because Missouri State was a little bit slow. Obviously, that long road trip, and now they're showing that they have the speed as well as well as the physical play. And they're using it here in the second period and getting two quick goals here in the second period. Now back to the play, Missouri State with the puck. Now back up to Brown. Brown takes a shot and block it away by Alex Hare. Alex Hare now he gets it by Missouri State. Missouri State takes it back. They're looking for back around, and it looks like Missouri State tries to take a shot. Nedzula takes it away. Now a 2-on-2. Gorzica and Nedzula gains the zone. Gorzica looking for a shot, and he takes a shot all the way up. They had a good chance there as Roble came all the way back out to him. Davis ended up giving a nice, juicy rebound off his mask there, but Roble just couldn't quite get it.
That was a bouncing puck,
yeah.
And Roble just couldn't settle it down. It didn't look like he hit it on the right part of the stick. It was a bouncing puck. There's nothing he could do on that.
Yeah, but a good job by Gorzica there, just getting the pucks in the net, trying to find a good lane there. And Roble now sends it, and now it's the freshman line of the Tommy Turner and number 4 Mano of NIU. They try to send it in there, now taken away, and now the Ice Bears try to send it up the ice. Now Mano back with it, ends up losing it, and now Turner takes it. He tries to send it to the middle. Now shot, and it just goes wide of Alex Hare. Now he whiffs on it. Number 19, Sadorf, and Sadorf ends up losing it. Now back over for one of his defensive teammate. Now Turner back up for number 8, Aldag. Aldag ends up sending it back around the boards as Missouri State keeps it in the Husky zone. Now Alex Hare sticks that away all the way back up to Aldag. Aldag looking for a shot, looking for a lane, and ends up shooting it just wide of Alex Hare. Now back up
Alex
for Sadorf.
Turin looked like he got that. Oh, there he went and slapped the goalie with the stick, and here we go.
And it looks like there's going to be a big scrum here.
Now Alex Hare's in a fight in the corner. The refs had to tackle someone down. Looks like an NIU player. Looked like Alex Hare did something that number 10, Alex Turin, didn't like. Looked like he was favoring his left side, went and slashed Alex Hare, and then the fights broke out.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a penalty on NIU because I saw Davis going off the ice there.
Yeah, it looked like a penalty on Alex Hare. He went and took a cheap shot at Alex Turin.
Yeah,
he didn't like it.
I think it might be two guys in the box for NIU here. It's going to be Mano and Tommy Turner.
Mano retaliated on Alex Hare. There's going to be two penalties.
And just to quickly point out, guys, there was a penalty before everything started.
That's what I was saying. That's why I said Davis was going to the ice. So, yeah, it looks like it is going to be a 5-on-4 here for Missouri State. So, yeah, and Rosinski and the captain for Missouri State, one of the captains, Aldag, are trying to figure out what is going on here. And like we said, it looks like it's going to be Turner turning for Missouri State, who's in the box for them.
Vince Mano and Tommy Turner both in the box for NIU. Do you know if one of them is serving a penalty for Alex Hare?
I think Mano is serving the penalty for Alex Hare, and then Tommy Turner, I think, obviously is getting the fighting penalty against Turner, and both of them are in the box. But it looks like it's going to be 2 minutes for Mano, 2 minutes for Turner, and then 2 minutes for Turner. And it looks like it's going to be a 5-on-4, I think, here.
Yeah, 16:46 to go here in the second period. Missouri State leads NIU 3-0. And you're saying the fluke goals are you said to avoid those fluke goals, and then right out of the gate, Missouri State goes and gets two of those kind of flukish goals.
Like you were saying, if you just get pucks in the net, you can get garbage goals like that.
And they've done it twice.
And they've done it twice now. Out of the three goals, two of their goals have really been kind of garbage goals that kind of just trickled in and trickled past Hare.
And then, of course, you had the one in the first period that was off of a tip, which it was a nice shot. I mean, that
it was, but I mean, it was. I think it was an off a pad of an NIU Husky.
Yeah.
So I think all three goals so far from Missouri State have all been kind of garbage goals. I mean, but that's what you got to do: just get pucks in the net, and that's what could happen.
You can't put it in the back of the net if you don't throw it out there.
Yep. And it looks like Hoglund is going to win the faceoff and gets it back to Aldag. Aldag now over for Ryan. Ryan takes a shot all the way up into the mask of Alex Hare. And it looks like he's a little shaken up there after getting a nice puck in the mask there. And it's going to come back out with 16:39 left here, 1:54. And like we say, it's just going to be offsetting penalties for Turner and Turnin for Missouri State and NIU. And then Mano's going to serve the penalty for, I think, Alex Hare. Now Rosinski wins a nice faceoff there. Rosinski now with the puck, trying to keep it, and sends it around for Brian Pounds all the way over to Schwartz. Schwartz gets it up for Nick Leon, and Nick Leon just couldn't quite find the pass all the way down to the other end. Davis ends up sending for his teammates. Now back up for the Ice Bears. Now Hoglund gets it. Sends it over for his teammate Ryan. Ryan looking for a lane. Ryan takes a shot, ends up getting blockered by Schwartz there. Good defensive play there. Schwartz now sticks it away. And now Nick Leon gets it, and he's just going to send it up nicely as the first penalty kill unit there does a nice job. Brzezinski now comes out, and Nedzla takes his place.
Now that was too bad. They almost found him on a breakaway.
Yes.
Pass
now Jake
too
Ryan.
Hot to handle.
Now Jake Ryan now with the puck takes a shot all the way back to the boards as goes past Alex Hare there. Now Missouri State gets the puck back looking for a lane as NIU is doing a good job of taking all the lanes away. Now Aldag tries to go for the middle of the ice. He ends up getting the pass, but just quite not in the reach for the shot. Aldag takes a shot. Good job by Schwartz there, sticking that away, and that finds out of the zone and all the way back to the center of ice. Now Aldag over for his defensive teammate, number 22, PJ Adams there. Now all the way back down for Davis. Davis is going to take the puck there for Aldag. Aldag looks like he's kind of the captain of this power play unit. Sends it up for Ryan. Ryan makes a nice move there around Nedzla. And now he's got some speed going into the zone. Now Ryan looking for a shot, takes a shot on Alex Hare, tries to find the five hole, but good save by Alex Hare. Almost another scuffle there between Ryan and I think Brian Pounds there, but just didn't have anything of it. Now 15:06 left in the second period, 3-0 Missouri State.
Alex Hare has been terrific on this penalty kill. I mean, it's been a long penalty kill because you're killing off.
You're getting off the one penalty, but, I mean, you're right. I mean, they haven't had a lot of chances. Alex Hare is doing a nice job of really finding the puck and making sure that they don't get a fourth goal to really put this game out of reach.
He's made a couple big saves.
And now Missouri State takes another shot, and it almost gets through. And it does get through, actually, Alex Hare, and goes to the back boards as it goes wide of the net. Now Davis gets the puck, trying to find one of his teammates, and he sends it around for Halamecki. Halamecki now gets the puck back, looking for his teammate. And it gets it up to Brown. Brown makes a nice move around Coletta. Coletta ends up sticking it away and all the way down for Hare. And Hare just decides to cover that up as the penalty for both. All three guys are going to be over, and it's going to be still 3-0 Missouri State.
That was a great penalty kill right there by NIU. And maybe that's what they need to get the momentum back in their favor. All they need right here is to get a goal. No one's going to score three goals. Just get them back one at a time and play your game. NIU wins the faceoff there.
And now Missouri State back with the puck. And now a good steal there by Coletta. Coletta could have a nice 2-on-2 here. Looking for a lane and gets it taken away there. And now Missouri State's going to have some room. Now Townsend goes up the ice with some speed. Townsend takes a shot all the way wide of Alex Hare. All the way around for Brown. Now Brown takes it. Now taken away. Another some speed here by Sveda. Sveda looking for a lane. Sveda gets it taken away and sends it to the middle. Now Townsend has it after taking it away. Townsend ends up getting checked in the board by Sveda. And obviously we know last week Sveda does have some good checking ability, even though he's a smaller guy.
That pass was just a little behind him, or else they might have had a chance at making it 3-1 game.
And now Sveda gets it taken away there at middle ice. And we see Jake Jouch out there, the big boy over on the far side boards for the first time, I think, in the game I've seen him. And now Luciana is trying to take it away. Now Coletta just sends it up the boards, gets it out of his own half zone, and now it's all the way down for Missouri State Ice Bears. Tries to send it up, ends up missing all of his players, and now Coletta is going to send it all the way down again, all the way around Davis. Now Adams looking for a lane, gets it to Keenan, his teammate. Now Keenan over for number 24, Patrick. Patrick back to Keenan. Keenan looking for a lane, and it's going to be an offsides on Missouri State. They were trying to gain the zone there. I think Keenan was doing a little bit too many moves there as his teammates were trying to stay behind him but just couldn't quite do it.
You know, it looks like NIU's not really attacking the puck when Missouri State has it. They're just all going back. Like, no one's going and throwing the stick in front, trying to get the puck back. It's that they're not attacking the puck. They're playing more of a defensive game, even though they're down 3-0.
Yeah, it looks definitely like they're more on their heels this period, which they really need to get away from because they need some goals in this period to get back in this game. A good takeaway there by McClue, and McClue ends up taking it back for the Missouri Ice Bears.
And one thing that's interesting is that their checking game has looked pretty well so far in this game, so I'm kind of a little puzzled why they're not going and attacking the puck a little more.
And a big check there by McClue there, and now and Coach Chuck is looking for a penalty, as I think it should have been a cross check, and he is very mad that there was no penalty after Rosinski got taken down by McClue. And now it's going to be going all the way back down as McClue tries to send it up for his teammate. And now Alex Harris sends it around for Brian Pounds. Brian Pounds has the puck now up for Riccardi. Riccardi just sends it after getting a big hit there. And now it looks like the Ice Bears have the puck back. Sadorf sends it up for his teammate, ends up missing him all the way down. And Alex Harris looking for an icing, no icing, as it doesn't quite make it all the way down. Brian Pounds now back up for Schwartz. Schwartz over for Rosinski. Gets it taken away, and now a big chance here by a turn, and he gets it taken away. Good job by Brian Pounds there, saving Rosinski after losing it, the puck in his own zone. Now looking for it, and he tries to go top shelf on Alex Harris. Alex Harris got Alex Harris down, and now all the way over to the near side boards. Now Riccardi has it. Riccardi looking for his teammate, Nick Leon. Gets it up for Leon. Leon's got some speed. Looking for a shot. Gets over Riccardi. Riccardi takes a shot and a big save by Davis. As Davis did a nice job of post to post as Riccardi almost got it over him but just couldn't quite get enough lift on the puck. And now back from Missouri State. Missouri State looking for a lane in the middle. Now taken away and now all the way over to the far side boards.
Boy, that would have been a big play if they could have put it in. That's what they needed to do is get a big goal right there.
Yeah, with about almost halfway through the period here, they need to get a goal, try to get back in this game.
Right, now just get a goal here, and then you're only down two going into the third period, and then you can get another one to early in the period, and then you got the momentum right there.
Yep, and now all the way over for number 11, Otten looked for a middle lane, all the way back out for Sadorf. Sadorf now over, trying to find his defensive line mate over there, and now it's back for NIU. NIU trying to catch the Missouri State Ice Bears in the chains. Now Roble with the puck, trying to find a lane, tries to go backhand, and tries to go under the pads of Davis there, but Davis was having nothing of it. As 3-0 here, 10:52 left here in the period.
Yeah, one thing I've noticed about when Alex Harris been playing the puck, there's been two times he almost turned the puck over, and Missouri State almost turned that into a goal.
Yes, and now the second line of NIU is going to be out there of Luciana Sveda and Greenberg. They got to try to help out this first line. First line has had a lot of good chances, but just hasn't been. But the second line, they got to do much better of getting some chances here. And now back for Missouri State. Missouri State gets the puck back, looking for a lane, and shoots from Brown. And Brown, good glove save there by Alex Herron. You can see here from the fans, they like the save by Alex Herron there, as a good shot there from Brown.
He's been terrific this period. I mean, other than two fluke goals, I mean, he's made a lot of big saves in this period. He's kept them in this game.
He definitely has, and he did that a lot last year, trying to keep them in some games, but sometimes the defense have been a little bit sloppy here in the period, but he has had a great period, Alex Harris. And now back up for Ryan. Ryan just takes a blind shot, ends up going all the way to Harris, and Harris just going to cover that up.
There goes the helmet on top of the net.
And Alex Harris kind of got taken down there as his player Coletta was getting pushed into him from, I think, the captain, Hoglin. And obviously Hoglin, I think, is going to go to the to the bench here, and I think it might be a power play for NIU as Hoglund just kept kind of going after Coletta there, and Coletta really wasn't doing anything. So it looks like it's going to be a power play for NIU with 10:31 left in the period, 3-0
Missouri State. This is what
they need. Yes.
I think this is their first power play. No, their second power play of the game.
I think it's their
third. I think there was offsetting penalty.
Yeah, I think you might be right. You're right. I think it's their second power play of the game. But their first power play, they really didn't get a lot of chances. So they need to do a much better job. Obviously, their first power play unit of Luciano, Leon, and Riccardi at the forwards. And then Rosinski, a center, is playing the defense with Herlin. Herlin kind of the captain of the first power play unit.
They're just trying to get anything going, get any offense they can out there.
Yep. And now Nick Leon has the puck over for Rosinski. It gets taken away by Jack Ryan. Herlin's trying to get it back, trying to stop Jack Ryan. Jack Ryan takes a shot in, a beautiful shot by Jack Ryan there, going over the glove of Alex Hare. Herlin tried to get back, and it's going to be a shorthanded goal with about 10:14 left here in the period, 1:44 left for the power play for NIU.
That was just an unfortunate bounce right there and a great shot. I mean, that was just a terrific shot by Missouri State. I mean, I was actually wondering if NIU is going to be able to get back there in time and force him to pass it back because it was about to be a 2-on-1.
Yeah, I think Alex Hare was kind of looking for Jack Ryan to go short side there, but he ended up going glove side, and I think he kind of got Alex Hare off guard there. And now it's going to get back for NIU as it's going to be the second power play unit. Tommy Turner is kind of the captain now. He's looking for somebody going around for Nedzula. Nedzula gets the puck over on the far side board. Up for Mano. Mano over for Sveda. Sveda gains the zone. Sveda looking for a lane. Sveda goes around Davis and looking back for Mano. Gets it taken away. Now Tieren. And I think they stop play here. I think it's going to be.
It's looking like another penalty.
I'm not sure. Is it going to be a penalty on Missouri State, I guess?
Yep.
5-on-3. So this is where you got to get back in the game. If you can get at least a goal here, maybe two, I think you could get right back in this game.
I mean, you could score right here on the 5-on-3, and then yep. You still got another power play, and then you capitalize on that. I mean, this game is not over.
It's definitely not over. A lot of time left, about 30 minutes left in the game. About minute 16, I think. I can't quite tell from the scoreboard, but I think a minute 16 left in the first power play. And then there will be about 45 seconds of the next power play, but unless they can score quick here on the 5-on-3.
This is where you have to capitalize, and Missouri or NIU is going to win the faceoff.
And so back up for Herlin. Herlin looking for a lane. Now over for Luciano. Luciano over for Coletta. Coletta looking for a shot, and it gets blocked away nicely there by Missouri State. I think by Adams. Now back for Herlin. Herlin now blocked by him, and then Luciano gets the puck back. Missouri State doing a nice job of blocking the puck. They're doing a great job on penalty kill in this game. Now over for Leon, almost finding him on the backside shot. Couldn't quite find him on the shot. Now Herlin over for Luciano again. Luciano over for Coletta. Coletta tries to find a lane there, but couldn't quite get it on net. Now Alex Hare is going to try to catch Missouri State in the chains, but Missouri State gets a quick guy out there. Now Leon with the puck.
Less than 30 seconds to go on that first penalty.
Yep. And now Leon gets rubbed off the puck and goes all the way back down. Maybe one last quick rush here with 20 seconds left in the first power play. Coletta trying to gain the zone quickly here. Gets it over for Luciano, but gets taken away. Coletta keeps it in. And Herlin was getting back, so he wasn't over where Coletta wanted him to be. Now all the way back down, and that first power play is going to be over as Hoglund comes out of the penalty box and now down for Coletta. Still 40 seconds left here in the second power play. 5-on-4 now. Nick Leon looking for his teammate, Justin Rosinski. Justin Rosinski trying to gain the zone, but gets it taken away there, trying to make some moves. And now down for Nedzula. Nedzula gets it taken away, and Missouri State tries to send it out, but it hits its own teammate, Jack Ryan. And now up for Coletta. Coletta looking for a shot. Ends up going wide. And it goes all the way to Nedzula. Nedzula couldn't quite find a shot there. I think it ended up going off the post. And now he gets blocked away by Jack Ryan. Jack Ryan now back with the puck. And that's going to do it for both power plays. And it's still 4-0 here. Jack Ryan takes a shot. And it's fifth goal here by Missouri State as it came back out after Jack Ryan with an initial shot. And back out for, I think, his teammate.
That was a rebound goal right
yep,
there.
Yep, a rebound, really, just a really good, juicy rebound. And I think it was, 16. It looks like I think 16. It was 16. That would be Keenan. And it would be the assist to Jack Ryan. Jack Ryan just did a nice job there. And Alex, they really couldn't do a lot about that rebound.
A lot of these, I mean, are just kind of bad luck goals. I mean,
yep.
Yeah, the two that just squirted it in at the beginning of the period, you got the one that just goes right to a forward that's right behind it. I mean, that was a great save by Alex here, and then Brad Keenan was able to put it in.
And just like last week, they were down only 1-0 to U of I last week, and then they ended up letting them out of their sights in the second period, and they're doing the same here. Now back to play as NIU has the puck in the Ice Bears zone as they send it down around the boards, and now all the way back out for Brian Pounds. Brian Pounds now in his own zone, sends it up the boards for Cantillo. Oh, Cantillo gets smashed in the boards, and we don't like seeing that because we know Cantillo has some concussion problems the last couple years. And now back up for NIU. NIU looking for Schwartz. Schwartz takes a shot, ends up getting blocked away there. Now Brian Pounds has to do a quick back check there as he gets the puck back into the zone as it goes back out for Keenan. Keenan with the goal just a minute ago, looking for another goal. Now Keenan gets the puck taken away as Leslie now has the puck. And
big
now,
hit by Keenan.
And now it looks like it goes to the freshman, Finley. Haven't seen Finley a lot this game, but he's had some good chances in this game. Now all the way back up for Patrick. Now Townsend looking for a shot. Blocked away by Alex Harford with the pad. And looks like whistle's going to blow. I think the net came off the moorings there as it's still 6:30 left here in the second period. 5-0, still Missouri State Ice Bears.
And, I mean, they had some great chances, especially on that 5-on-3. They had some great chances. The only problem was they were missing the net.
Yep, and they were missing the passing lane. I mean, they were finding the passing lanes, but they were they were missing hot passes that were right there, and they just couldn't quite find the net.
Right, yeah, missing the net. I mean, they haven't been generating many shots on goal this period, and NIU will win the faceoff right there.
And it back to play as Gorzyka ends up getting taken away. Now Tommy Turner around the boards, trying to find Gorzyka all the way up to Patrick. Patrick finds his teammate, and he ends up getting blockered away by Tommy Turner. Good stick there. And they're going to send it up the boards, but I think it was deflected by one of their own players, as now NIU back with the puck. Tommy Turner sends it up the boards again. Good keep in there by Patrick. And now, again, NIU's having a really tough time with getting the puck out of their own zone like they were last period at the end of the period. And they're having some of the same problems here.
They're getting tired late in the periods.
Yep. And it looks like Nedzula is going to try to get it out, but it gets taken away. And now Missouri State takes a shot. And just a nice rebound there coming out for number 18, McClue. And McClue, actually, I think that's his first goal. And that is just another.
That was a beautiful goal.
That was a nice goal. Just sending it to the net. Alex Hare giving up a rebound. That was some of his problems last year. Even though Alex Hare is a great goalie, sometimes he just gives up too juicy of rebounds, and they really get some nice rebound goals usually. And that's what we saw last year, and we're seeing some of that last couple goals here as they're down 6-0 with 5:35 left in the period.
Again, it's only the first game of the season, so it's something, some of these kinks that you're able to work through the whole season, it'll probably get taken care of. I mean, NIU's got to get something going offensively.
And now Greenberg tries to find a lane there, as you just say that, but it ends up
deflected
out of play up into the netting. But yeah, you're right. NIU, I mean, this is their first game, so they're obviously going to figure out all the mistakes that they had here tonight, and they're going to get, and they got a game against Missouri State again tomorrow because they have it back-to-back games, obviously. But you're right. They definitely do need to find some mistakes here. Down 6-0 left here in the 5:30 left here in the period.
Good keep-in right there by
Coletta. Coletta, good keep in there by now, all the way down to Greenberg.
Greenberg's behind the net right there. Now kick it back out to a defense. Oh, he's going to keep it himself.
Yep, and now Missouri State just sends it out all the way down to Herland. Herland now looking for the puck, and he's going to send it up to Greenberg. Greenberg just deflects it, as I think they're going to still call icing because he was still over the halfway point there. And 5 minutes left here in the second period. And just remember, after the second period, we're going to go down to Marcus as Tommy came back up to us, and now Marcus is down at the benches, and they're looking, and he's going to, I think, interview Anthony Riccardi after the period with about 5 minutes left. And now it's going to be back at Alex Hare.
And right thing, I mean, even though you're down 6-0, and it doesn't look like you're going to be able to win this game, Just create some offensive momentum, get some plays going, maybe score a goal here just to get the momentum going and give confidence to your offense.
Well, yeah, you definitely do need to get some confidence for tomorrow night's game because obviously you got to get a couple goals at least to give yourself some confidence for tomorrow night's game against the Ice Bears. As the Ice Bears get the puck back all the way up for Jake Ryan. Ryan up for Hoglin. And Hoglin ends up getting it taken away. Now Coletta with the puck up for Greenberg. Greenberg at the halfway point. Greenberg looking for a shot. A good shot over the glove of Davis. All the way now for Rosinski. Rosinski, nice hip check there on Brown. Now all the way over for Browns. And it looks like the defensemen are kind of pinching here a little bit more because they're down 6-0, obviously. And now all the way down for Coletta. Coletta trying to beat out number 20, Kovachuk, there. As they're fighting for the puck, Kovachuk ends up gaining the puck and looking for a lane. Now tries to find middle, but gets it taken away by Brian Pounds. Brian Pounds gets knocked off the puck as Patrick finds the puck. Patrick sends it to the middle, ends up getting it taken away. Now Riccardi ends up with the puck, and he's going to just send it over for Nick Leon. Nick Leon off the skate is a little bit too hot of a pass there, but not enough for icing as Patrick goes all the way down. Good job by Nick Leon there, keeping it in. And Davis is just going to smartly hold that with 3:38 left here in the period and 6-0 still Missouri State Ice Bears. And I think NIU has allowed this kind of game to kind of get out of reach here. But like you said, if they can get a couple goals, maybe get
just
some
momentum. Just to create
momentum
just for tomorrow's game, some confidence in the offense. And one thing, we haven't seen Anthony Riccardi on the ice for the last couple of shifts. He finally got back out there.
I think they've been out there for a lot of power play and penalty kill. They kind of getting tired of that first line.
They're the one that's creating the offensive chances.
Yep, exactly. And now it looks like it's going to go to Gorzaga as it gets it taken away. Now Townsend with the puck. Now Schwartz sends it up the boards to Gorzaga, ends up missing him. Now gets it sticked out of the air by NIU, but back to Keenan. Keenan with the puck. Keenan looking for a lane. Now just sends it down to the boards. Brian Pounds now sends it up to Roble. Roble ends up losing the puck all the way to Nedzula. Nedzula is just going to
finally clear the puck.
Yep, just clear the puck out as they were I think they're going to try to just kind of regroup themselves as it goes all the way down. Nice hit by Brian Pounds there. Nice hip check. Now Alex Hare is going to send that around, but it's going to get taken away by Keenan. Keenan now gets taken down. No penalty called as we see that the refs are kind of letting a little bit go here as we saw a lot of tripping.
Play.
Yeah, they're letting them play a lot. We saw a lot of tripping, I thought, in the first period, but they're letting them play. Now Brian Pounds back with the puck.
The refs have done a great job today.
Yeah, I think they've done a pretty good job. Not a lot of penalties, allowing the guys to play. And now we're seeing the fourth line go out there with Jake Josh. Good hit there by number 17, the freshman for NIU, Finley.
Seems like a little bit of the chemistry right now with NIU is off. Like, guys are passing the puck and thinking that someone's there and they're not.
Well, you got to expect that because, obviously you know that there's about 7 or 8 freshmen on this team, a couple of transfers, so it's
right,
going to
take. They lost some guys last year.
They've lost a lot. They've lost some seniors, so it's going to take a couple games for kind of chemistry to kind of gel with each other. So obviously, we're seeing in that game as Tommy Turner and Mano, the freshman pair, are back there. They're just going to send it around the boards all the way down. I don't think that's enough for icing, as it was tipped by I think a Missouri State Ice Bear.
And even though the score says 6-0, NIU definitely has not played like bad enough to indicate that would be the score. They've actually played pretty well defensively. Now offensively they've had some troubles. There's been some fluke goals, so 6-0 does not kind of makes it seem like they didn't
save.
Play very well.
Big save there. I'm sorry to cut you off there, Ryan, but a big save there by Alex.
That almost went in. Yeah, that was another big save. He's been terrific this period.
Yeah,
he's allowed 5 goals except 3 of them really kind of fluke ones. I mean, that doesn't even count all the big saves that he made, like goals that probably should have gone in.
And now Riccardi tries to send off for Tommy Turner. Tommy Turner pinching there a little bit now. They're going to get a chance here from number 23, Franco. Franco tries to send to the net, and they're going to stop play here with about a minute left here in the game. 6-0, Missouri State. And I think they're going to stop it.
So, I mean, obviously, again, 6-0. I mean, they didn't play very bad, and it looks like NIU's sending a guy to the box.
Tommy Turner, it looks like he's going to get a penalty here. So I think that's the third penalty on NIU, and I think the second power play for Missouri State Ice Bears.
And that's the one thing they didn't need right now.
Yes.
I mean, like, you need to get your offense some momentum, and this isn't going to help. However, getting the penalty kills some confidence, being able to stop them, especially when they've scored 6 goals, because this would be I don't think they've scored on a power play yet. That puck is tipped,
and it goes
wide of Alex Hare.
That's very true, because their penalty kill had a lot of trouble last week against U of I. U of I ended up getting four power play goals on them, I think, last week out of the seven goals. So you're very right about that. Getting some confidence for the penalty kill would be very nice here to go end into the period. Now Missouri State back with the puck as his number eight, Aldag, sends it up for number 11, Otten. Otten leaves it for his teammate. Looking for a lane, all the way back up for Adams. Adams looking for Aldag. Aldag was waiting for the puck. Aldag now tries to find the lane, goes down for Hoglund. Hoglund all the way up into the mask of Alex Hare there. Good save by Hare.
Another big save by Alex Hare right there. And a strong penalty kill.
Yep, so far.
Very strong penalty kill. As you said, they allowed four power play goals against U of I. It looks like they got that taken care of, because the penalty kill has looked really good in this game.
Yes, penalty kill has definitely, I think, been the bright spot of NIU in this game, even though
right.
they're down
6-0. When the time in this game they're able to clear the puck out of the zone as NIU wins the faceoff and dumps it down to the other end of the ice,
and
they
that
clear.
Should,
and that should end the period.
That should end the period with about 2 seconds left here in the period. Davis is just going to send it around for Townsend. And that's going to end the period with about a minute and a second left in the power play for Missouri State to come into the next period. 6-0 with the end of the period here. Ryan, what were your thoughts on that period really quick before if we send it down to Marcus?
Well, when you see five goals a lot, do you think they had a horrible period? NIU did not have a horrible period, and Alex Hare was about to go jawing at some of the Missouri State players. The refs turned him back. Looked like he was going with Alex Turin. They allowed five goals, except they still played very well. I mean, the penalty kill was terrific. They were really facing a lot of shots that period. The offense really didn't get it going. They had a 5-on-3, and I don't think they recorded a shot on that, except the penalty kill has been terrific.
All right, Ryan, well, thank you for that. We're going to send it down to Marcus to see his recap on the period.
Just a very frustrating first period for the Huskies. Missouri State definitely took the physicality to a completely different level, and the Huskies were not able to keep up. I think what they need to do in period number two is just keep the speed up. They can't match Missouri State physically wise. They need to get the speed up, get the puck through the neutral ice into the offensive zone as quickly as they can, and just keep getting shots on Davis. Once Davis gets a little frustrated, he does tend to give up goals, and that's what you saw against the Junior Blues. So if they can do that, then you guys, we should see some more goals in period number two. Now back up to you guys.
Thank you, Marcus.
Marcus, thank you for that. And we are going to go to our first break here after the second period. We'll be back for a recap of that first period. Look to the third period. And the third period will consist of Marcus going back to the play-by-play. But we'll be right back here on ChicagolandSportsRadio.com after a 6-0 slashing of the second period. And thank you for joining us.
Tom Waddle here, and I know you've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? Interested, aren't you? Don't waste another minute. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. Classes taught by industry pros with affordable tuition and job placement assistance. Apply now for spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you could start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Your friend Tom Waddle here. You've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? You're interested, aren't you? So why haven't you done anything about it? Don't waste another minute in a career you don't love. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or TV reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, you'll learn key skills from industry pros while working with professional equipment on air and behind the scenes. Still need to keep the 9 to
9-to-5 job, their flexible class schedules can work around any schedule. Short on cash? They have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports? You have drive and determination, but you need the skills to work in the industry. This is Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. ICB provides hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn how to work on air and behind the scenes with internships and job placement assistance at stations like ESPN Chicago. You can start a new career in a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. You know you want to be here. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You can have a new career in 1 year. This is Tom Waddle for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get caught in the high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or television career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you get. Flexible class schedules, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports today. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Start a new career in 1 year. What's up? It's Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get stuck with high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or TV career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you'll get. Flexible day and night classes, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You know you want to. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
And welcome back to NIU's Huskies hockey as they are down 6-0 after two periods of play. 1 minute, 1 second left for the power play for Missouri State. Now I'm with my other color man, Tommy Castanova. Tommy, what did you think of that period? You were doing the stats. Obviously, you were watching the game. What did you think of that period overall?
Well, first of all, I just want to say I'm happy to be back with you guys here at NIU Hockey.
We all got our nice jackets now.
I know. We're like the official crew now. It seemed like it was going to be a good period from the get-go, and then it just kind of went way downhill real fast. I know when I talked to Coach Ronaldo after the first intermission, he told me that they were basically right in the game, and it really looked like that in the first period. But then as soon as those two goals got scored on quick, then the third one a couple minutes later, it really deflated that team and took all the momentum away.
Yeah, well, I was telling Marcus in that first period I was really worried because it looked like Missouri State were a little bit slow, but I was really worried because you knew that Missouri State was going to come out in the second period because you know they're an offensive team, but it's just a long bus drive for them. I think it's like 10 hours. So I was just worried that they were probably a little bit maybe tired from the bus drive and everything. So I knew that they were going to come out in the second period and use that speed on us, and you could see that. And now they're up 6-0 after that period.
Yeah, that's usually what happens to a team that has to travel a good distance away. You usually got to find your legs after the first period. And it seemed like they were ready to go as soon as that second period started. NIU really wasn't, which is a shame because it really seemed to help the Huskies in that first period. But they weren't really able to use their speed a lot in that second period. I think the Ice Bears are starting to be a little bit more physical on the defensive side and on the offensive side, creating a lot of turnovers, which led to the Huskies' demise.
Now, what do you think NIU needs to do? Obviously, I think this game might be over, but unless they somehow have an amazing comeback. But what do you think NIU needs to do in this third period to get some momentum for the next game tomorrow against Missouri State?
Well, I think it's got to start with that first line of Rosinski, Leon, and Ricardia. That was the biggest line for the Huskies last year. And I think that's where you guys look for. Your star guys got to step up and hopefully energize this team. I know a couple of the freshmen early on, one guy in particular who I looked at in the first period, where is he?
Which number?
No, not Tommy Turner. Oh, John Luciano, who really had his legs in that first period. Looks like he can be a good offensive weapon for the Huskies, but it's got to be someone like that to step up.
He's one of the two transfers out of that big freshman class, but he is a transfer with Leon's brother, actually, at goalie. He's the backup goalie. But Luciano is one of the transfers. He's a big guy. I've said that he's going to be the main guy, I think, in that second line this year. He's got to use that size and that good puck handling skills from him. And I really think that he could be a big help on that second line with Greenberg and Sveta.
Well, and like you said, there's a lot of freshmen coming in. There's a couple of transfers as well. So they've kind of gone back to square one with the young team here. You really don't have too many older guys. I mean, we know Leon, Rosinski are a bunch of the veterans.
But other than that, there's not really too many veterans still on left on this squad, and you got to find ways to step up here. So I look for a couple goals here in this third period for the Huskies to bring some momentum for tomorrow's game.
Now, if it were you and you were Coach Chuck or Coach Pickett, what would you be saying to your guys in the locker room to kind of get them a little bit fired up for this third period?
I mean, you got to tell your guys, hey, I mean, yes, you're down 6-0, but any game is winnable at this level especially. And you just got to give it all your heart. They really got deflated towards that end of that second period. No one really had any energy. So I'm just telling my guys, hey, come on out. Come out with some of the fire. We saw what happened when Missouri State did that. They came out with fire in those first 2 minutes and scored two quick goals. So anything can happen here in hockey.
Yeah, you really hope that NIU has some momentum going back into the third period when the third period starts in about 7 minutes. We're going to go to our final break before I send it back to Marcus for play-by-play in a couple minutes. But we're going to go to our final break before the third period here. Thanks for listening to us. I'm your play-by-play. For second period, my play-by-play will be Marcus on ChicagolandSportsRadio.com.
Tom Waddle here, and I know you've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? Interested, aren't you? Don't waste another minute. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. Classes taught by industry pros with affordable tuition and job placement assistance. Apply now for spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports, you have drive and determination, but you need skills to work in sports broadcasting. Hey, this is Tom Waddle, and I'm here to tell you how to get those skills at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Get hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn to be a host, producer, or shoot and edit video. With internships, day and night classes, affordable tuition, and job placement assistance, you could start a new career in less than a year at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Your friend Tom Waddle here. You've heard great things about the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, haven't you? You're interested, aren't you? So why haven't you done anything about it? Don't waste another minute in a career you don't love. You can be the next great announcer, DJ, producer, or TV reporter. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting provides hands-on training in radio, TV, and online media. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, you'll learn key skills from industry pros while working with professional equipment on air and behind the scenes. Still need to keep the 9-to-5 job? Their flexible class schedules can work around any schedule. Short on cash? They have very affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. You'll have access to amazing internships and job placement assistance when you graduate at top radio and TV stations like ESPN. Apply now for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting spring classes and start your new career in less than a year. Learn more at beonair.com/Chicago Sports. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You love sports? You have drive and determination, but you need the skills to work in the industry. This is Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night and instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. ICB provides hands-on training for a career in radio, TV, or digital media. Learn how to work on air and behind the scenes. With internships and job placement assistance at stations like ESPN Chicago, you can start a new career in a year. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports to put the ball in play. You know you want to be here. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
You can have a new career in 1 year. This is Tom Waddle for the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get caught in the high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or television career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you get. Flexible class schedules, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports today. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
Start a new career in 1 year. What's up? It's Jonathan Hood from Chicago's Game Night, an instructor at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Don't get stuck with high tuition that a 2 or 4 year college will cost you. Train intensively on your radio or TV career for 1 year with affordable tuition. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, here's what you'll get. Flexible day and night classes, hands-on experience, amazing internship opportunities, and excellent job placement assistance. Put your passion to work. Visit beonair.com/Chicago Sports. You know you want to. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports. What's up? This is Jonathan Hood from ESPN Chicago. People often ask me, Hoodie, how can I be a sports radio guy like you? I tell them it takes drive and determination, and you need to learn how it all works. At the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, you can do just that. ICB is enrolling students for day and evening classes now. Listen up. You can learn to be a sports talk show host, a producer, do play-by-play, and shoot and edit video. You'll have a chance to get internships at stations like ESPN Chicago, where you can tap into the knowledge of industry pros. With job placement assistance, you can start your new career in 1 year. I also teach at ICB, so I know firsthand that it's a great school to get the hands-on training you need for a broadcasting career, doing what you love. They have affordable tuition and financial aid for those who qualify. So don't waste another minute. Go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports and see what the Illinois Center for Broadcasting has to offer. That's beonair.com/Chicago Sports.
And we're back here at Fox Valley Ice Arena, just about ready to start period number three. Huskies find themselves down by a half a dozen. One more for the touchdown. Tommy Turner will have another minute and 1 second of penalty time to serve. From down there, guys, like I said during that intermission report, the physicality was just completely taken to another level on Missouri State's part. And like we've seen the last few years, that is not Northern style of hockey. It is more like the Hawks. You want more speed, a little bit more finesse through the middle of the ice. And Missouri State has definitely won the neutral ice battle in this game.
Yeah, that's definitely one of the things I noticed when I was down on ice level as well. They were trying to use their bigger bodied guys to kind of push the Huskies around. I mean, I know number four, Bobby Brown, is a big boy down there. He was definitely throwing his weight around. And I think it really caused a lot of frustration in the Huskies as well, taking as many penalties as they did in that period. I believe they took three or four minor penalties in that period with a couple offsetting each other. But I think they've got to go back to their own game. They can't let – that's what happened a lot last year. I know working these games, that when the Huskies tried to become physical and get away from the speed, it really didn't work out for them in the end.
Yeah, just, you know, they have to dig deep here. I mean, first game, opening night, home opener, you're down 6-0. We've seen it before. The Hawks have come back from, I think it was 6 goals down against the Calgary Flames a few years ago, 5 or 6 goals. So it can be done. But Hare needs to play better. They have to not give up, you know, a shorthanded goal. They're not producing on the power play either.
Yep, that's a big problem too, especially when your first line is supposed to be as productive as they are, especially with last year with Rosinski and Leon being the bigger guys that they were.
Has it really just become about now winning the period?
Yeah, because, I mean, you still have to play tomorrow. Right now, you're winning. You have to play to win the period, get the momentum, and try to split with Missouri State and at least get a few points in the mock of gold right off the bat, because the way the schedule's set up, you're home today and tomorrow, then you're on the road for 4 weeks. Yeah. Central Michigan, Iowa, Illinois, and Northern and St. Thomas in Minnesota.
Yeah, you'd like to think you can get as many points as out of this first weekend, especially being at home as you could. I mean, this Missouri State team's a tough team. You just got to find, like you said, you got to dig deep here in this last period and come away with something.
You look at those four teams that you're going to go on the road against. Last year we split with Illinois. We swept Iowa last year. St. Thomas and Minnesota is a new team for this year in our schedule. And then who was the other one? Central Michigan. We split with Central Michigan last year. So there are points available on the road, but this is where you want. Home cooking is where you want to get the 2 points a game, because we know how difficult it is to win on the road no matter what hockey conference you play in.
Yeah, you gotta take the points when you can. And being a younger team, I guess they lost a lot of the older guys last year due to graduation and whatnot. So with younger guys, you really want to have that momentum going into the tough road schedule that they have coming up.
Like we said, they got 8 true freshmen on this team, 2 transfers. So a lot of new pieces to this puzzle, still trying to learn the system, still trying to figure out how everybody's style of play works together on all the lines. Looks like it's going to be Nedzla, Coletta, Sveda, and Herlin to finish off this minute of penalty kill time for Tommy Turner. 6-0, Huskies will be moving left to right on your screen. Missouri State going right to left in the maroon jerseys.
Yeah, and I think if you're NIU here, you got to do exactly what the Ice Bears did to you last period. Score within the first minute of this period, maybe get another quick one, and then who knows how it's going to go in the end.
And like Coach said when he talked to you, they like to take chances. So if they're going to give you power plays, you need to take advantage of those opportunities. So we're underway here in period number three. Huskies trail 6-0. Taking now Eric Aldag, now to Otten. Otten cross ice pass finds P.J. Adams. Adams, centering attempt. Hare sticks that one away to the far side corner boards. Now Aldag takes a shot from the top of the right faceoff circle, and that one goes just wide. Now back out to neutral ice. Adams gains the line left point. Herland rubs him off the puck. Sveda's able to control, but not out. Adams, good glove save, top of the right faceoff circle. Goes down low now looking for Ott and finds him. Back for Hoglund. Goes behind Alex Dare. Ricochets to the right side corner boards. Husky zone. Here's Ron Coletta now. He goes off of Sveda, and Sveda clears it down. 10 seconds. That's going to do it for the penalty to Tommy Turner. And that's another aspect of the game that the Huskies have not been able to do tonight, is clearing the puck on the first attempt. It's taken them 3-4 times to clear the zone.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was going to talk about. And that was the big problem last year, is when they couldn't clear the puck, the other teams created a lot of turnovers and scored a lot of goals off of them.
Puck back into the Husky zone. Leon chops this one out to neutralize. Finds Justin Rosinski with Riccardi up with him. Rosinski waits, shoots, tries to go top shelf, and it goes up off the glass. Staying in is Kevin Schwartz. Now it's Anthony Riccardi, and they're going to call a hand pass on, I believe, Anthony Riccardi. 18:33 left in the game. 6-0 is the score in favor of Missouri State.
Yeah, and this is the line you got to be looking for here on the early going of period number three. Rosinski, Leon, and Riccardi, they definitely made their presence felt in that first period, but I felt they went away in that second period. So if you're looking for guys to step up like me and Steven had talked in the intermission, this has got to be the line to do it.
Rosinski in the faceoff circle. Top line is out there, and it's taken by Keenan. Keenan gets the puck back in his own zone, backhands it up off the boards in front of his own net, in front of his own bench. Townsend gains the line right point. Schwartz takes him off the puck, but Townsend gets it right back before taken away by Justin Rosinski. Rosinski now finds Riccardi streaking up the left side, gains the line top of the left faceoff circle, shoots and goes off the blocker of Davis. Leon gets taken down there by Hellman Maki, and it finds Rosinski left side half board. Center attempt for Leon, but he was tied up nicely by Hellman Maki, and that one goes out of play. Watch out down there in front of the glass.
And I think one of the things that the Huskies did well in the first period as well is where they did a lot of dumping and chasing, and it really was effective because the Missouri State was still trying to find their legs at this time. And I think when you dump the puck and you give yourself more of a chance rather than try to bring up the middle, because Missouri, like you said, Missouri's going to look to counter as much as they can.
Yeah, the forecheck has not been as effective as Coach Rinaldo has wanted it to be. Mm-hmm. Sure, they get it in deep, but Missouri State has had 2-3 guys back in retrieving that puck and allowing them to break out. Luciana up through the middle of the ice, gains the line. He gets it back, right face-off circle, ice bear zone. Sveda's in there along with Adam Otten. Sveda wins it, center attempt looking for Greenberg, but Otten took him off the puck. Gets deflected out of play, 17:35 left in the third, 6-0 ice bears.
Yeah, and I think this line as well, Luciana centering here, he's looked like one of the better players for the Huskies so far in the going of both first and second periods. I look for him to maybe jumpstart this offense a little bit more and see what he can do.
Faceoff won by Missouri State goes up off the boards and back out to neutral ice where Tommy Turner can control. Through the legs is Sveda back in his offensive zone, taken now by Eric Aldag. Aldag up off the boards for Turin. Turin gets it out to neutral ice where Greenberg can corral the puck. Now back for Aldag. Looking for Otten, it was, I believe, and Bouchite. But it's going to be Vince Mano to regain the puck for the Huskies. Mano up off the boards, can't clear it. Now it's taken by Greenberg over the Fox Valley logo, gains the line, right point, top of the right. Faceoff circle, shoots with a weak wrister into the breadbasket of Davis. He covers up, 16:57 left in the third. 6-0 is the score.
And I think if you're NIU as well, they really haven't given Justin Davis that much of the business tonight.
Yep.
They've really put a lot of weak shots on him. I haven't really seen any too high-quality shots. I mean, that Rosinski one a couple minutes ago was probably the best one I've seen all night. They really haven't made him work for his money tonight.
And they really haven't screened him either. They have not had anybody in front of the net to get any kind of deflection. Here's Nana, takes a shot, goes off the outside of the cage. Centering attempt goes through the blue paint off a Sadorf stick. This one is taken in nicely by Patrick Roble. Roble finds Gorzica, but he gets taken off the puck, and P.J. Adams clears it out to neutralize in front of the Huskies bench. Herland in his own zone, goes cross ice for Coletta. Coletta looking for Gorzica, but it hops over his stick. And they pump it back in, does Missouri State. Herland now finds Gorzica. Gorzica has it picked off by Adams and neutralized. Now gains the line left point. Goes through his legs. Gets taken down nicely by Troy Herland. Center attempt. And it comes back out. McClue from the point. Takes a shot. Bouncing puck. And Looks like it deflected off of somebody out in front, and Hare had to be careful with that one. Now it's taken by number four, Bobby Brown. Bobby Brown gains the line as Missouri State's going for a change, and there's going to be a delayed penalty call up against Northern Illinois. And 15:51 left in third, 6-0 score, and it's going to be Roble again.
Yeah, if you're NIU right here, you've got to be a little bit more smart with how you're playing the game right now. They're taking a little bit too many penalties, and this Missouri State offense is too good to give them multiple chances on the power play.
And Roble had four penalties last week in the preseason game, so still an undisciplined freshman, and that's something they just have to learn. They can't take chances like that, and they can't take the penalties like that.
But I think as the season goes on, these guys will learn that. It's only the first home game, and it's the first regular season game of the season. So, I think they're just trying to find their legs as well for NIU. But like you said, being a freshman, you've got to kind of know when to do some things and when not to do it. And hopefully they can figure that out as the season goes on.
So Roble's actually going to get tossed here. Not sure what the call is. They're still waiting for it. Sadorf and Herland getting the call. So Roble's done for the game. One less forward out there for Coach Ronaldo. And it's Sir Pico Schwartz out there right now with Pounds. See who the other Husky is. I think that's Nedzla down there in the goal crease. And Finley's going to serve the penalty for Roble.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what the call was. I didn't actually see the hit as it happened, but obviously not a good enough hit.
I think it was a hit from behind in front of the Missouri State bench, and then so cross check and probably a game misconduct.
Yeah, you definitely
yeah,
heard
if it's
it
from 5 minutes,
here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So 5-on-4 for 5 minutes for Missouri State. And this is now what you want if you're the Huskies. Face off one. Now gets it to Brown from Sadorf. Brown swings it around, now back to him at the left point. Goes down low looking for Kovacic. He can't get it. Serpico chops that one up and out in a neutral ice, and Missouri State has to regroup. Sadorf over for Helmamaki. Picked off by Serpico. He's got some skating room. Goes down low, trying to go through the legs of Sadorf. But he gets it back to the right point. Kovacic doesn't know where it is, and he gets it back in. Townsend gains the line, right point. Now back over for Helmamaki. Brown's got it, left faceoff circle. Skates back to the point. Now down low for Kovacic. Wines fires out in and out of the breadbasket of Hare. Townsend back to the point. Goes down low for Helmamaki. Goes in, shoots. Big save made by Hare, and I think it actually was blocked. Whistle blows. So where'd the puck go? So referee lost sight of the puck. He blows it. I don't think Hare made that initial stop. I think it was Serpico with the shin pads. Sounded like some shin pads.
Hey, you're trying to help the goalie out as much as you can, especially with the kind of night Hare's had. So, but I think that's a big save and a big moment, especially with them being on this 5-minute major penalty.
So Rosinski, Leon, Herland, Coletta out there on the penalty kill. Hare in the net. Otten Adams, Aldeg, Ryan with a goal tonight. And Hoglund. Hoglund's got it behind here. Gets taken off by Ron Coletta. They battle for it. Now finds Otten. Otten centering attempt. Good stick by Rosinski to deny Jack Ryan his second goal of the night. Back to the point for Adams. Adams sends it in looking for a deflection from Jack Ryan. Couldn't get it. Now it's Justin Rosinski. He's got some skating room, and he finally gets it out of the zone. And Davis is going to corral. And pass it over. It looked like he was going to shoot that one down the middle of the ice. Here's Rosinski, shoots, and a pad save by Davis. There's a giveaway. Penalty kill working pretty well here for the Huskies. Only a couple shots on goal in this 5-minute penalty to Roble. Here's Hoglund. Hoglund gets the puck, and he comes out to neutral ice. Almost found Jack Ryan streaking up the left side. Could not quite connect. It's Otten now, swings around behind here. Herland picks it up there. Herland's going to go off of Hoglund, and he keeps in, and the second try, he does get it down the length of the ice. 2:53 left on the 5-minute penalty, 13:42 left in the game, 6-0 Missouri State.
If you're the Huskies here, I think you got to start taking more chances here on the penalty. You're already down six, Just trying to create more opportunities for herself as much as you can, I think, wouldn't hurt the Huskies.
As Nedzla tried to clear that puck, it hit a player on the Missouri State bench. 13:30 left and there, 2:39 left in the power play for Missouri State. And like you said, it's a good point. You got to start taking some chances. I mean, 13:30 left. I know what the idea is, to clear the puck all the way down the ice, obviously. But if you have a chance to skate that up to neutral ice and maybe get a shot on goal, test Davis. He hasn't been tested very much in this game.
Exactly.
Halmamaki's got it. Right face-off circle. Now to the point for Sadorf. Sadorf winds. Fires, gets blocked down front by his own man, Townsend. Sadorf goes down low, left side for Townsend in the corner. Harris sticks that one away from Tommy Turner. Sadorf, left hash mark, face-off in the left face-off circle. Gets it down low. Finds Townsend with a give and go and a good diving play by Nedzla as Kovacic tried to go play a give and go. And it's going to be Turner to clear it. And the whistle blows. I think, did Greenberg get a slash? And I think it's Halmamaki that's arguing the call. Let's see what the official call is. Looks like Halmamaki's going to go to the box. No penalty. Greenberg was bent over like he got slashed in the arm. So not sure what the call or what the whistle actually was. So Brown, Sadorf, Halmamaki out there for Missouri State along with Matt Townsend. Sadorf down for Townsend, left faceoff circle. Back for Sadorf at the point. Down low, Brown, and a big save made by Hare with the pad. And the Huskies clear. 1:47 left in the power play, 12:36 left in the game. Here's Sveda. Sveda has it taken away from him. Serpico was there too. Now taken by one of the five captains, Nick Sadorf. Giveaway to Sveda and a bouncing puck, and he couldn't stick a fork in it. Back out comes the Missouri State Ice Bears. Halmamaki gains the point left side. Sauce pass down low, looking for and connecting with Brown, but Pounds is there to stick it away. Brown gets it back, right point. Down low now for Kovacic. And they go cross ice through the blue paint. They can't connect. It's Sveda's able to clear the zone. Halmamaki takes Sveda off the puck. Goes cross ice for Bobby Brown. Brown back now and connecting with PJ Adams. Adams over neutral ice, gains the line. Takes a shot into the glove of Alex Hare with 52 seconds left in the power play. 11:42 left in the game. 6-0 Missouri State.
Yeah, I think you could tell NIU is trying to take as many chances as they can whenever they can, but Missouri State's doing a good job of handling the puck, keeping it in the zone, and it's working out so far for Missouri State. They've had a couple good chances on Alex Hare, a little bit more sloppy than you'd like to see from the Huskies.
Luciano wins the faceoff, and Pounce clears it down the length of the ice. Back to control is Aldag in his own zone right faceoff circle. And we got a penalty upcoming here. Hand is up. Let's see what the call is. And it's going to be on number 22, PJ Adams. So that's going to negate the Missouri State power play. We'll have 4-on-4 hockey for 38 seconds before the Huskies will go back on the power play, down 6-0 with just under 11 and a half minutes left in period number 3.
Yeah, and Marcus, I've been looking at Greenberg over there on the bench. He seems to be laboring a lot. Not sure if it's that right arm or is that left arm on, or if it's his leg, because he came off limping a little bit, so I think he might have just took the stick where it hurts down there, but not too sure on his status for the rest of the game.
Yeah, from this point, it looked like he was bending over as if his right arm was ailing him a little bit, but he's up on the bench shaking out his legs, so maybe it was a lower body injury. Leon out there with Pounds, Luciana, and Rosinski to finish off this 4-on-4. It's going to be Sadorf grabbing the puck and clearing it. Not out. Good keep there by Rosinski, but they couldn't do anything with it. Pounds neutral ice up off the glass. And it's taken by Nick Leon. Leon over behind Turin. Now Leon gains the line right point, Missouri State zone. Here's Justin Rosinski for Leon, and a deflected puck goes just wide on Davis. Here comes Jack Ryan. Ryan gains the line, left point, takes a shot over the crossbar of Alex Hare. Finley's out of the box. He's going to go to the bench, and the Huskies are going to have a minute and 10 seconds of power play time here with 10:40 left in period number 3. Here's Brian Pounds, has a little spit skating room, goes over the middle of the ice. Here's Pounds now, dumps it in the left side half boards. Now Leon at the left point, takes a shot, patted away by Davis, and another shot by Nedzela is into the breadbasket. 10:25 left in the third, 6-0 is the score. 50 seconds left on the power play.
And exactly what we saw right there is exactly what we want the Huskies to do, keep getting pucks to the net. Yeah, there are a couple of decent shots there, but just trying to get as many, create as many chances as you can for yourself, trying to get to the puck to the net. Rosinski to Leon almost seemed like a shoe-in there, but just wasn't enough.
Troy Herlin now down for, who is it down there? I think it's Riccardi. Nope, it's Serpico. Herlin shot goes through the legs of Sveda, and Davis is able to make the save. Serpico can't corral the puck, and Missouri State clears it down the ice. Alex Hare back to control. Here's Herlin now, waits behind Alex Hare. Now he comes out with the puck. Finds Coletta. Coletta just out in front of Nedzela, couldn't corral it. And Missouri State is able to recontrol the puck with Eric Aldag. Aldag clears it down. Hare's there to stop it. 15 seconds left on the power play, 9:42 left in period number three.
And I think something I've noticed on the power play here for the defenseman-wise, at least, is they haven't really found that guy that's going to be their point man on defense. I mean, last year they had Troy Hickey and Brian Pickett working that top point, and they really haven't found the guy yet, I don't think.
I thought, at least in my eyes, that Herlin was going to be that guy after Pickett left. He showed a lot of improvement last year along with Ron Clutta, and right now, you know, through one preseason game and almost one full regular season game, you really haven't seen anybody step up on the defensive end. Aldag goes over for Sadorf. Now finds Leslie in front of his bench. Franco backhands it, but not into the offensive zone as Max Finley can control. Finley gets taken off the puck nicely there by Nick Sadorf. Sadorf dumps this one in. Franco to retrieve. Pounds takes it away from Franco. Jake Jouch is out there now. And Leslie takes a shot into the glove of Hare, and he blows the whistle. Hare wanted to play that one. Nothing new on 8:45 left in period number three. 6-0 is the score.
I'm not sure how it happened, but Missouri State seems to have slowed this game down a lot, and that's really never going to favor the Huskies. I know they like to use their speed, but nothing seems to be going right for the NIU Huskies right now. They've got to find someone that's going to step up for them, and it remains to be seen who that will be.
Jake Jouch out there now with Finley and Gorzica. Gorzica gains the line left side. Center attempt for Finley, had his stick tied up by Franco, so he couldn't get anything on it. And a big hit there by Finley on number 18, McClue. McClue and Finley still jawing. McClue sticks Finley with it. And now we're going to have a penalty upcoming on the Huskies, Finley. As McClue speared him in the chest and no penalty was called. So interference is the call. Hitting the stick away from was Finley. It's another power play here to Missouri State with 8:16 left in period number three.
Yeah, and if I'm Coach Chuck Rinaldo, I'm not going to be too happy with my team right now, taking a lot of careless penalties here, especially when we've talked about trying to gain momentum for tomorrow's game. They're just not playing to the level that they should be playing, and I don't think anyone's going to be happy with this result today.
Yeah, we thought coming into this game that this is – well, obviously this is the most deep team, I think, you know, skill-wise that the Huskies have had in the last 3 years, at least since I've been here. But like you said, just have not been able to put things together tonight as Hare makes the save about 7 seconds into the power play. If you're Chuck Rinaldo, what do you say to these guys tonight – in that locker room to kind of get them ready for tomorrow?
I think you guys got to just tell them to shake it off. It's one game. But I think you got to look back on that first period. And, yeah, Missouri State may not have had their legs in that first period, but you saw Huskies came out with a lot of energy and were really willing to work for everything, basically, in the game. And, it was 1-0 after the first, but you just got to go
in
the same mindset tomorrow. Yeah, you got to have that mindset for tomorrow.
This puck bounces out in the middle into the neutral ice. Rosinski can't control. Otten can, though. Otten back for Aldag. Aldag skates it. He has some speed. Pretty good skater is Eric Aldag. Now goes cross-ice, finding Hoglund. Hoglund has it picked off by Leon, and he sends this one just out of the zone where Adams was able to jump up and grab the puck. Big hit there by Leon, and they're going to call a penalty. Wow. I don't know how you can call a penalty on Nick Leon. And now we got Schwartz and Hoglund going in on it. Alex Hare's in there too. We got a big scrum here. I don't think Schwartz was very happy with the way that that Alex Hare was dealt with. Hare obviously can stand up for himself. Pounds was in there. Rosinski was in there. That was a good clean hit from Nick Leon.
Yeah, maybe a bit of a questionable call there. I don't know. I think these refs are trying to make sure this game doesn't get out of hand for either of these teams, but I don't think that was the right call there by the refs.
That was a good clean hip check by Nick Leon. And I think Schwartz is going to get tossed. So is to Hoglund. So we'll reset and see what the penalties are going to be.
Harry got tossed as well.
So Jake Leon is going to be in the new goaltender for the Huskies. First regular season action. He played one period against Illinois in the preseason. Looked pretty good. Still getting getting loose as being an ACHA goaltender. But Chuck Rinaldo very high on this goaltender, Nick Leon's younger brother. Had a little trouble moving laterally last week and wasn't able to really go, post to post very well. But that was one game. He's had a lot of practice time. We'll see how he does in a game situation, a regular season game situation.
Yeah, and this isn't the right time that you want to really bring him in this kind of circumstance. But I guess for the Huskies, it could work out in their favor as well, just to see him get some regular season action right now while he can. Yeah, you don't ever want your goaltender to get kicked out of a game. But if you're just trying to get the young guys experience while they can, I guess you can take it.
So right now it's Jake Leon in goal for the Huskies. Hare was tossed, as was Kevin Schwartz. Finley's in the box. Leon's in the box. Hoglund got tossed. We'll see if anybody's going to serve an extra penalty for Missouri State. I don't think they will. It's going to be a faceoff to the right of Jake Leon. Hellman, Maki, Brown, Townsend. And Kovacic. It has just been one goon squad of a game starting in the second period when the Missouri State scored 5 unanswered goals.
And yeah, that period really ran pretty smooth. When I was down there, it went pretty fast. Not too many stoppages. It slowly worked its way into a slow halt here in the third period.
Here's Rosinski winning the faceoff. And they clear it down. So 5-on-3 for 1:08, and then a 5-on-4 to kill off the rest of that power play time. Grabbing it is Matt Townsend. Townsend's spinorama move. Out in front of his own bench, gains the line at the right point. Skates in right faceoff circle. Now goes down low to the left of Leon. Brown to the point. Now to the captain, Nick Sadorf. Sadorf back for Brown, top of the left faceoff circle. Now for Sadorf. Brown winds and fires, and Jake Leon makes a blocker save. As you can see, every time he kind of goes one way, he struggles to get back and find his feet. Sanger attempt goes back to Townsend. Back to the point now is Sadorf. Sadorf down for Brown. Brown waits, looks, goes back to the point for Sadorf. Brown gets knocked down, but it goes over for Yusso Helmimaki. Good pick off by Rosinski, and a good shot there by Rosinski.
And
Rosinski's going to go to the box. That was a good clean hit by Rosinski, and so I have another power play. And now we got some more shenanigans going on in front of the bench. This has been one heated game starting in the second period.
I think you're just seeing the overall frustration of the Huskies starting to come out finally. They're using these big hits to maybe make a statement towards the Missouri State, but it's not working out in their favor, as a lot of guys are being sent to the box, and it's just getting out of hand really quick.
That was a good hit by Rosinski. Maybe a little high, but caught him from behind. And you normally don't see Rosinski as more as a physical type of player. I mean, he's more of a skill player. He kind of stays out of your way. But when he has an opportunity to take somebody out, he's going to take it.
Yeah, he's one of those guys I think most people aren't going to suspect him of creating a dirty hit or any kind of hit at all. So when it does happen, it kind of surprises you.
There's one of the camera ladies down there in the box. She's got a full box with her. It's Rosinski, Leon, and Finley in there, and the camera woman. So, you know, life goes on.
They might add another extra penalty minute. I'm not sure for the broadcasting
team. Is she
team.
Serving a penalty too? I mean,
she
might as well be, right?
Games, yeah.
Might as well, the whole game might as well be. Just throw a jersey on her. We'll just start sticking Huskies in there.
Well, you got to feel bad for her because you know it's going to smell in that box right now. With all three of those guys.
I will pass because I know what a locker room smells like.
Yep.
I do not want to be down there right now.
Hey, that's why we're up here, right?
She's a trooper.
Yes, she is. I think next time we should throw a hockey helmet on her so she, you know, she's a little bit more protected.
Or something.
Hockey helmet, mouth guard, pads. I'll just bring my whole bag and we'll just stick
her
in
there. We'll just give her a glove in case she wants to give someone a shot on the way around.
Just a mean right hook from coming out inside the penalty box.
What are you doing?
Yeah, just skate. Just it's like a drive-by punch. Just a right hook from the penalty box. I don't know if she's the kind.
Somebody be skating by and she'll just stick the arm out there and just level them, sort of almost clothesline them.
Just
arm
make bar. It look, just stick it out there and hopefully nobody sees it and she clotheslines
it. She could get the ref, you never know.
That'd be fine, the way they've been calling this game. I'd be all right with that.
I'm surprised the refs just haven't called this game already with how many penalties and
all
this
I'm surprised
nonsense.
I haven't seen a white flag yet.
Yeah, that's true. They've kept it under wraps so far, but I don't think it's going to happen too much longer.
All right, we're back. Seedorf down for Brown. Brown shoots into the chest, in and out of the chest of Hare, but the whistle did blow. 6:20 left in the third. 6-0 Missouri State. 5 seconds left on the Finley power penalty.
I think
he'll
that,
be out.
I think that name you're looking for is Leon.
Jake Leon?
Yes.
Did I say Hare?
Yep.
Dang it.
But it's all good.
I'm still getting used to it.
They kind of look the same. They've got the same kind of gear, except for Leon's got a black mask and Hare's got the white mask.
I was kind of hoping Bovey would play tonight with the Husky helmet. It's got a big old Husky head on his helmet. So that one gets shot up over the over the crossbar by Jack Ryan. Ryan gets it back, top of the right faceoff circle. Now for Seedorf. Seedorf back skates, shoots into the glove of Jake Leon. Good save by the new netminder. 5:59 left in the third, 6-0, 30 seconds left on a Leon power penalty.
Yeah, with the amount of penalties that the Huskies have taken here in this third period, it's they haven't scored a goal yet on the Missouri State side, so you gotta take something in what's happening here at the late stages of this game.
Faceoff won by Missouri State. Seedorf looks, now goes cross ice and finds Jack Ryan. Back for Seedorf, now to Ryan. Right faceoff circle, in and out of the glove of Leon, and he makes the save. Looks good so far on three tough saves. Mm-hmm. 5:52 left in the third, 6-0.
And like I was saying, this is his time to impress the coaches. I mean, if you're looking for more ice time down the road, I mean, we know Hare is the starting goaltender for the Huskies, but if you're looking for a guy in the future, this could be the one.
This one jumps back out to neutral ice. Picked it up as Jack Ryan skates with it, gains the line at the right point, stops and loses control, and the puck comes back out to neutral ice. Cross ice for Hellman Maki, and it's going to be an offsides play on Missouri State, something you don't like to see on a power play. 7 seconds left on the Leon power play. 1:19 left on the Rosinski power play.
And with two of the guys that usually kill penalties for you, Rosinski and Leon, both in the box, I'm sure there's other guys stepping up right now for the NIU Huskies when they're shorthanded.
Coletta, Herlin, and Nedzla out there for Chuck Ronaldo. Nedzla wins the faceoff, but it's controlled. And finally controlled by Missouri State. Eric Oldag takes a shot from Leon, who's just jumping out of the box. 5-on-4 power play now for another minute for Missouri State. Coletta sends this one back out in front of the Huskies bench. Aldak can control for Missouri State. Going cross ice now for PJ Adams. Adams back for Aldag. Aldag has it picked off by Leon, but Kovacic is able to return the puck. Now for Otten. Gains the line at the point. Another offside. There actually, no, we're going to have some jawing here. Nick Leon. Leon and Adams jawing at each other. I don't think anything is going to come of it. Just they kind of, it's just like wrestling, jawing at each other, staring at each other.
Yeah, I think it's just It's just all come to fruition now. There's no rhythm or pace to this game whatsoever. Teams are just trying to hold it on here for the last 5 minutes. And hopefully no one gets any kind of other misconduct penalties or even gets suspended for a game, because if you're on a NIU, you just got to get out of here with everyone intact.
Yep, just kind of got to just survive this last 5 minutes and regroup for tomorrow. Eric Aldag now has it taken away and from Herland. Kovacic is able to regain the puck. Back from Adams is Kovacic. Cross ice finds Aldag. Aldag shoots, and Leon sticks that one away to the right side half boards. Now Kovacic, left faceoff circle, back to the point for Aldag. Aldag down low for Otten. Otten back up for Aldag. Aldag now for Otten. Otten winds, fires, that one gets deflected off of Kovacic's stick over the crossbar. Good hit there by Sveda. Now taken by Eric Aldag. Aldag has it taken away from him by Sveda, and he gets lit up. And that's going to be a penalty on 22 P.J. Adams. It's about time a call like that has gone the Missouri State way.
Yeah, I really leaned into him with his shoulder, lifted Sveda off the ground with that hit. I wouldn't be surprised if this is a more than a minor penalty, but maybe not.
So P.J. Adams in the box, two-minute minor. Rosinski's got 2 seconds left, and he'll be out of the box, and Huskies will actually have some power play time with 4:17 left in the third, trailing 6-0.
But that really wasn't a surprise hit for me at all. Adams has been one of the guys that's been the most physical for the Ice Bears tonight, along with Hoglund as well, who actually got kicked out of the game about five or so minutes ago. So I think they're just trying to send a message at this point.
So Luciano Riccardi, Herland, Pounds, and then Rosinski will go out on the ice for the first power play unit. Riccardi has that one turned away by Davis. Helmanmaki can't clear the puck. Rosinski can't keep it in. And finally, it's going to be Bobby Brown to get it out of the zone. Riccardi dumps it back in, but Helmanmaki's there to control. Helmanmaki sends it back out to neutral ice. Pounds corrals for Herland. Now Rosinski. Rosinski finds John Luciano. Luciano in on Helmanmaki. Shoots, and it just goes off the outside of the glove of Davis. And the Ice Bears clear it down with 3:45 left in the third, 1:25 left in the power play.
Yeah, and if you're ever going to take anything away from this game, it's got to be right here on this power play. Hopefully they can gain some momentum going into tomorrow's game.
Riccardi sends this one around, takes a hit in doing so. Rosinski retrieves left side or right side corner boards, Ice Bears zone. Luciano back up to the point for Pounds. Pounds waits, shoots, and that one goes out the outside of the cage as he was looking for deflection from Rosinski. Puck's cleared down by Aldag. 57 seconds left on the power play, 3:12 left in period number three. Troy Herland corrals it from Jake Leon. Gives it to Pounds. Pounds looks and finds Rosinski, touch pass, finding Riccardi. Gains the line at the left point, trying to go through the legs of Seedorf, can't do it. And it's Kovacic, or Westcott, excuse me, getting the puck and clearing. Now it's Westcott and Nana. Nana and Westcott, two on one. Shoots, big save, or deflection made by Leslie. Or excuse me, not Leslie, that it was Tommy Turner who helped his goaltender out. And Turner's going to retrieve. 20 seconds left in the power play, 2:36 left in period number three. Turner for Leon, through the middle of the ice, gains the right point. Serpico's there with Westcott. Now Leon right face-off circle. Down low for Serpico. Serpico looking for this pass. Goes out for Mano. Mano throws it around the boards. Both teams are at full strength as Adams is out of the box with 2 minutes left in period number three. Puck finds Leon. Leon's got a little skating room, but a good job there by 18 Brandon McClue to get back as Serpico point blank sends that one over the crossbar and out of play. 1:58 left in the game. 6-0 is the score.
I guess there was a couple of good chances there on that last power play attempt for the Huskies. They were trying to take advantage of the opportunities that were presented to them. But if you're trying to take anything away from this as a Huskies fan, you just got to say today was a game, tomorrow is another, and that's how you got to look at it here. Just get everyone off intact and prepare for tomorrow.
Here's Ron Coletta keeping it at the left point. Wines fires, that one goes just wide of Davis. Now Jouch is out there. He keeps it in at the right faceoff circle, but it's taken by Adams. Adams looking for McClue, but McClue couldn't handle the puck.
Now it's Franco. Franco gains the line, left point, shoots into the chest of Leon. He holds on. 1:33 left in the third. 6-0 in the score. Stay tuned right after the game, or right after the final whistle. Stephen Duffy will have an interview with assistant coach Brian Pickett, and then we'll wrap things up and get ready for tomorrow night's matchup at 5:00 here, as Northern Illinois looks to split the weekend series and get their first 2 points of the year. Josh trying to chop that one out of the zone off of McClue and Franco, and finally it is cleared by Max Finley. Bobby Brown in his own zone just waits, killing off some more time. Gets the puck back through the middle of the ice. Now it's Troy Herlin looking for Finley. Couldn't corral the puck. Now back in his own zone is Yuso Halmanmaki. Halmanmaki gives it over for Ryan. 1 minute left in the game. 1 minute, 6-0 is the score, as the Huskies are just going to have to regroup. Here's Keenan. Keenan in on Leon, and he shoots that one going across his body just wide. Here's Jake Jouch. Jouch sends this one back into the offensive zone. No icing called. Corralled now by Bobby Brown. Brown now finds Keenan. Keenan looking and finding Bouchette. Bouchette finds McClue. McClue gets taken down from behind by Coletta to not allow him into the offensive zone. 25 seconds left. Here's Eric Sveda. Sveda takes a shot in the glove of Davis. And he's going to hold on and get a faceoff. 21 seconds left in the game. 6-0 is the score.
Yeah, I think there was an opportunity miss there as Serpica was going hard to the net. Sveda just didn't see him in the right time. And I mean, a good shot on goal, but again, Davis really wasn't pressured too much.
21 seconds left in the game. Serpico loses the faceoff, controlled now by Eric Aldag. Aldag sends it back into the offensive zone. That's going to be an icing call with 15 seconds left in period number three.
At this point, I don't see why that call was made, but that's just how it's going tonight. In this,
that's just the way, slow, you know.
This is how the cookie crumbles, I guess, in this game. I mean, if you're just trying to end the game, I think you would have just let that go if you're a referee. But hey, the white stripes got to do their job, right?
You know, they're just doing their job. You really can't complain.
Nope.
Eddie Olczyk and Pat Foley say all the time, they're the fastest sport in the league, and they have to make a split decision call. And that's gonna do it for today's game. Stephen Duffy is gonna talk to Brian Pickett once he comes out of the handshake line. 6-0 is the final score. Duffy. Tommy, first thoughts on today's game.
It started out great and then ended up not so great. I mean, if you're the Huskies, you gotta take solace in the fact that you came out, played a hard first period. It was only 1-0 going into that second period, and that's kind of where it all fell apart for the Huskies. So if you're gonna take anything out of that game, and the fact that bringing the energy has got to be the biggest key for the Huskies going into tomorrow's game, and you can't let this physicality take control of the way you play your game and the thinking of how you're going to play your game. You can't let Missouri State suck you into that kind of game. Just use your speed tomorrow. Got to use that physical when you can.
Yes, when you can. You cannot,
not every time,
out dominate or out physical play the Missouri State Ice Bears. It's just not going to happen. They're such a big team. Like I said during the second intermission, you have to use your speed to your advantage. You have to win the power play battle, and you have to win the neutral ice battle. I think those are two keys that the Huskies are going to have to look at to, get back into this game.
Yeah, and if you're the Huskies, I think if you're the Huskies and Alex here, I think you're going to want to talk to your teammates about maybe playing a little bit less sloppy in front of you. I mean, yes, Hare gave up a couple of soft goals in that second period, but there was just too many chances where those many goals weren't going to be allowed.
All right, we're going to send it down to Stephen Duffy, who is with assistant coach Brian Pickett.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with coach, first-year assistant coach Brian Pickett. Now, Brian, obviously that was a rough and frustrating first game for the season. Obviously, you played U of I, but especially that third period, a lot of penalties. What were your overall thoughts on that game?
Well, if you look at it, 6-0 was 1-0 after the first, 6-0 after the second. That was a 0-0 tie there. Not too bad other than all the chippy penalties. But overall, lack of effort wasn't all there. We had a bunch of letdowns in the second, just like we did against U of I. So if we can figure out how to play a second period, put the puck in the back of the net, we might have a game on our hands.
Now, like I said, this is your first year coaching. You were a player last year. What do you think is the difference between being a player on the ice and kind of coaching behind the bench and kind of yelling at the players and the refs a little bit more?
Well, yeah, it's fun talking to the refs, but obviously can't do it like I did last year. But, you know, being behind the bench and not actually being on the ice, I still get to disseminate some knowledge to the players. Last year I was looked as one of the leaders, so, you know, it's good to be back and involved.
Now, what are you looking for tomorrow for your NIU Huskies? How do you think that they should come out tomorrow so they can maybe take and split this weekend?
They need to come ready to play. First 5 minutes of the game, we looked like we were dominating them. And then we had a mental breakdown, 4-on-4. Shot block went in our net, and everyone just collapsed after that. And like I said, second period is what we got to focus on.
All right, Coach. Well, let's hope that it's a better outcome tomorrow, and thanks for the interview.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, Steven, with assistant coach Chuck Rinaldo. We're going to wrap things up here from Fox Valley Ice Arena. We will be back on the air tomorrow night, 5 o'clock puck drop. Missouri State looking to split the series. We will also carry the D3 game tomorrow, which will be on directly on after us at 7:30 puck drop. So for Steven Duffy, Tommy Castronovo, Ryan Risky, I'm Marcus Grasser. For the entire ChicagolandSportsRadio.com team, ICB team, we thank you for listening. Repeating your final score, Huskies lose the home opener 6-0. So long, everybody.